Hi, welcome all of you. Nana here, and then we are into the next week session on procurement. Actually, we have completed 1 week, and then we have completed all the 6 approvals, and then now this week we are going to see accounting. It's very tough. And then my personal opinion or the suggestion to all of you is that try to avoid accounting. Fine, always try to push it into the cost accountant team or the financial accountant team. They will not try to hand it over to you, and then with the over enthusiasm, if you take it up in your head, and then you will be having it. You will be finding it very difficult. Actually, it is not an easy one, and so you will not see about how to do it. Actually, in a smaller company, you only have to do it because they were not having multiple resources basically, and so purchasing accounting will be pushed onto your head actually, and then whereas in a bigger company, they will definitely have resources. Try to convince your project manager that this is not your cup of tea, and then but in fact, what happens if it is being pushed into it, you only have to do it. So we will not see purchasing accounting here. So before we start purchasing accounting, we are now going to have a look at the catalog categories, which I have not explained very clearly actually. So let me go and share my screen now. So let me first of all log in into eBiz, and so explaining in eBiz is really easy actually. Here it's somewhat cumbersome actually. I've given you eBiz login credentials over here. Now, but please don't change the passwords, otherwise I myself will not be able to log in. And then we cannot create any users at all. No users can be created. And then if you change the password, that's all lost. It is lost for everybody. So please don't change the passwords. People will be having the habit of changing the passwords. I don't understand why it's so. I've already lost one such instance. And then the second instance I got, please don't change it now. Fine. So I go there. So let us now go to the eBiz, and then we'll now have a look at it now. So the one. eBiz is R12.2.6. We are going to go there, and then we are going to see the catalogs categories now. This place, I will not take the username over here because there it is a mother document, a mother ERP for Fusion ERP actually. And then it has been done so nicely there. Here they want to make some modification here and there, and then it's somewhat not exactly fitting to the needs actually. I go there, I don't need the login. I mean, eBiz, those who don't know eBiz, don't worry. Fine, just watch only. Fine, you need not have to worry because I'll be going very fast on this place actually. eBiz, if you don't know, please don't worry about it. Because if you're clear, you can even tell me afterwards. No, fine, once when I complete the catalog categories part of it. So, once
sir, clear, sir. I can tell me.
So I'm in the inventory, I go there, I go to the setup part. So the setup is basically replaced by your application implementation consultant. So only when you give the application implementation consultant, you'll be able to do the setups. And similarly here, if you exclude the task, the end user cannot do any setups at all. Every setup is available only in the setup area. And double click on it. Setup. I will now go to flux fields. Go to the key. Not the flux field actually. Setups. Now go to items. Forgot on the navigation actually. Categories. Yeah, setup items categories, and then we have one what's called default category. One thing is what? One second. Setup item categories. Category codes. Default category sets. Forgot on the navigation here. Category sets. Default category sets. Yes, default category sets. Setup items categories, default category sets. Double click on it. Yeah, this is the one. So in eBiz, we have only this many functional areas. Inventory is area, purchasing is area, planning is area, likewise, this many areas. All of them do not belong to SCM actually. Right? Some of them belong to some other modules basically. So in fact, what happens, it has been enhanced. Now it is more than 25 or something like that in Fusion actually. And every functional area is basically denoted by one category sets. The category set is known as a catalog in Fusion. So your functional area is what happens is mapped to one category set, or every functional area is assigned one category set. You're assigning a category set to your functional area. This has been made ultra in Fusion. You'll not see in Fusion. So for a functional area, we can have only one catalog. The category set is known as catalog. So we can have only one catalog for every functional area. You cannot have more than that. So in Fusion, what they did is, now go there, click on it. So I will now go to the place, go to the setup and maintenance. Go to this place and then click on search. And then manage functional cutoff. Go to the task now. So manage functional area catalogs. They made it in the Ulta manner actually. I don't know why they have done like this, but this is what it is. So they create a catalog and then assign it a functional area. So for example, the catalog is now created. So here, whatever for the functional area, you assign a catalog actually. For every functional area, go there and then assign it. Here it is not so. You create a catalog and then click on the assign. Now it's ordinary. I'm going to click on assign. So let us say I want to do the assigning of the cost. It is not possible at all. If you go and try to assign the cost, cost is already assigned to something else and drop it down. I will now go to the cost and then try to give OK. That is not possible. It will not show because costing is assigned to another catalog actually. So here the area is assigned to catalog, whereas here catalog is assigned to area. And this is more easy, more nice actually. So if a costing functional area is already, what happens if you see the cost area is already assigned to a catalog, then cost cannot be assigned to any other catalog because this is clear now. Is this clear? Because
yes, yes, sir. It's clear.
So that means what? And what Oracle suggests strongly is it is for the training only they have done it now. They say that you create one catalog and then assign it to all the functional areas, preferably. That will be more appropriate and then more is a highly recommended practice. But here it is not. So, but people change because of so many reasons. For example, my team was having a VAT implementation. So for a VAT implementation, they have a separate catalog there. And then they have used it for purchasing. And similarly for the sales, we have some other thing. So for which, because of very many reasons, they may even go for a separate catalog. Remember, they may go for a separate catalog. Okay, fine. So otherwise, it is preferable to have only one catalog for all the functional areas. And then if you want to assign, you can now see how many functional areas are here and drop it down. So it's also almost similar to what we have now. Only thing is the VAT is an additional one. Apart from that, almost similar to what we have in the EBIS basically. I thought that
Nanan, practically the purchase person, the inventory person, the cost accounting person and own person are totally different. For viewing an item for the eye of all these person to look into that are totally different. Purchase person look at...
No, I will tell you one problem now. Fine. I will tell you one problem. Let us say we have a separate catalog for inventory, purchasing and order management. Let us say I have on desktop as a category. A category has been created as a desktop. The same category cannot be given to purchasing and then same cannot be given to order management because category names are unique across catalogs. So in which case, what do you have to do? You have to create a desktop and then desktop one and desktop two. Like that, you have to create three categories. So it is strongly advised to have only one category across very many functional areas so that what happens, category creation is simple actually. Fine. That way it works. See here, the costing, inventory and purchasing are more relevant. They have coupled everything to one catalog. And then if you click on it, what happens, you'll be having a category now. Categories are unique across catalogs. And so the same catalog you have to create in multiple names basically. The same name will not be allowed at all. That was a previous concept, but I don't know what the present concept now. Fine. It is a single level hierarchy. Remember, we don't have any hierarchical. One below the other, one below the other, it is not possible. Only on self-service procurement, we can have a hierarchy. Otherwise, for a purchasing, it's the only single level hierarchy. Have one catalog and then preferably assign it to multiple areas. Fine. That is the best one because we can have one category being created there. And then it will not be possible. Now. Fine. I'll go on and see. I'll make a test of it. Now. I will not go there. I will not create a category. Below category, I'm not creating a category. Fine. Test. Go there. The category code will be coming automatically. Test is the one. I'm creating it. Fine. Click on OK. So I have created a category called test under the purchasing catalog. Fine. Go there. So click on save. I've saved it. Fine. Go there. I will now go back one level. Give a cancel. So it is not done. Test is not done on the purchasing catalog. So on the planning catalog, I go there and then I will try to create the test again. Now, fine. Click on it. So planning is not there, fine. On the planning catalog, I go there. Let me try to create a test now. So click on plus now. So I will now put a test over here. See, it's not throwing an error. So it's not possible at all. One category cannot be assigned to multiple catalogs, remember.
Nana, yeah, it is giving an error only for the category name.
Yeah.
Category name must be unique, but the category code instruction can be tested.
But see, it will be confusing for you. If you have the name and code different, fine. If you say category one and then category code, that is not correct at all. Category code is again an error. No, fine. A category code is a unique representation of every category actually. What is the meaning of having desktop 1, desktop 2, desktop 3 for inventory procurement and order management? That's of no meaning as such now. If you have coupled all the three areas into one catalog, then the desktop itself will be valid for inventory, purchasing and order management. Got it? So it is not even accepting it, right? Because so it is highly recommended. Oracle is highly recommended to have only one catalog across all functional areas, so that you need not have to create the categories again and again with different names. Right? That's not possible at all. Category names are unique across all functional areas. And so what happens, the categories which are below the catalog, it will be very difficult if you have multiple names basically. Oh, I'm talking about desktop 1. Fine, that is for purchasing. Desktop 3 for order management. You will be confused on this. Got it now? But again, there are some implementation considerations based upon which what happens, you will now go for multiple what happens, the catalogs also. So this I'm not exactly clear, because I talked to our own team now basically. They told, you know, that for a VAT, we had to have a separate catalog, and then so on, so thing, we ought to have a separate catalog. So like that, they told some explanation. I couldn't understand that actually. But that is a generic logic actually.
So, sir, but here, how many functional areas do we have in this screen?
Yeah. If you go there and then click on assign, now find this many functional areas. Drop it out. This many functional areas. Asset management, etc. So you'll now see all the functional areas coming up. It's almost similar to what we have in EMS. We don't have much of a difference on this. Here, catalogs are assigned to a functional area. There, it is a ulta. Functional areas are assigned to catalog. Is the doubt clear or fine? So this completes the discussion on category catalogs now. But any doubts? Okay, we'll go over the next
one. One question.
Yeah.
As you have said in earlier sessions also, that catalog is collection of categories and categories is collection of items.
Exactly. Yeah, that is a three-level hierarchy actually.
Yeah.
Catalog, so now, category, and items. Yeah.
Yeah. Now you have shown in categories some names were written like bolts and washers. And so now I want to ask, if one of that categories is assigned to purchase catalog, so then that category cannot be assigned to any of other catalog?
I think I'm not sure about it. It's a good question whether the category can be assigned to other areas or not. Fine. I don't know whether it comes to the list of values or not. I'm not sure about it. It's possible. No. Fine. Only whatever is available in the below only can be assigned to that particular catalog. I don't think it's possible. When I have not tested it, but let us say I have desktop 1, desktop 2, desktop 3. If purchasing has got desktop 1, so desktop 2 cannot be assigned to this because it belongs to some other catalog.
Like here you can see category name is bolt, nut and washer.
Okay.
So and here you this is category. So this will be having collection of items.
Yeah.
So that category cannot be assigned to any other catalog.
Like inventory is a catalog. Fine. You have order entry as a catalog. You have planning as a catalog. You cannot assign to them. That will not be coming in the list of values at all. It won't be possible.
What if this been used in both catalogs?
It will be having a different name actually. Bolt, nut, washer and one. Fine. Bolt, nut, washer two. Like that it will be there. You cannot have the same category in multiple catalogs. These are all restrictions, and so what happens? You have to live with the restrictions actually.
So Nana, only these three catalogs are available in...
In this instance, these three are available. Fine. In some instance, maybe five. Instance to instance, you only have to decide in the field now. I'm not throwing this discussion to you by having a field discussion with your people basically.
So catalog is created or this is
catalog will standard. Be coming blank basically. You only have to create everything.
It's a small little confusion.
The right hand side, click on create now. Yeah, tell me.
Yeah, in this, left hand side, we have here EBG order entry, planning catalog, purchasing catalog. Like this, if we want to create one, then where is the...
The right hand side, you have create now on the top.
Oh, create. Okay.
Sir, if you assign any catalog to particular functional area,
okay, remember, here it is different. Here, functional areas are assigned to catalogs. Okay, fine. Tell me.
What my question is, like, if I create any catalog and it's assigned to some like cost or inventory purchasing, later we cannot remove it, right?
No, not possible at all.
But the if you go to edit mode, right, in functional area, there
not
is
allow
a remove option.
It will not allow you to remove at all. Remember, it will not allow you to remove. Remember, if once functional area is now assigned, we have to remove everything. One second. Let me put down the silent mode. Once when you assign, it is the same functionality in EBIS also. Here also, what happens? It is not possible at all for you. You go there. You go to the setups. You go to the items. and then you go to the what's called categories. The same functionality has been retained over here. Now go to the category set now. And then if I want to make a change, oh, there's no fine, go there, long go for any R, it's R specific actually. And then if you do it, it will not say, oh God, not the category sets actually. I want to go to,
you can go to default.
Yeah, default category sets. You cannot change it here also. In even infusion also. If you go there, I want to make it as change to purchasing, fine, give it app. It will not say Poda Ponga or anything if you want to make it. It will not allow you at all.
But there is a remove option, right, sir?
No remove, no nothing. Nothing can be done now. Fine, remember. If you remove it, you cannot save. How to save it now? It's not possible.
It's not here in Fusion. If you go to
Fusion, also it's not possible. You try. You make a try. It's not possible. The same thing, same concept only. If the first thing is what, you have to unassign all the items from the catalogs and then category combination, then it will be allowing you. If let us say some 5,000 items are already assigned, if you want to make a change, you cannot do it. You cannot do it. Any other questions on this? No, you know, spending a lot of time on this. No, fine with that.
Nana, one thing I just want to understand. That is clear. What my doubt is was there earlier. That is clear. But when I'm trying to change the default category,
no, not possible. Changing nothing, deleting is all not possible. Fine, forget it.
Oh, that one surprising error is coming. Like you, this purchasing must be organization control, but it is master level control always.
No. That we will not discuss later on. Fine, there is a small bug or something like that. No, fine. Everything must be master control except planning. Planning was only to be organized.
Yes, sir.
We'll come to the topic later. No, fine. The concept is clear. Now, fine. The concept.
Yes, is concept is now quite clear.
Good. Then. Now we'll not jump into what happens accounting, now, purchasing accounting.
Okay.
So we'll not jump into purchasing accounting. That is the catalog front. Fine. We'll now go into purchasing accounting. So you go to the additional docs and records. Fine. And then you go not this one. We'll now go to 2.2. And then we'll now first of all go to what's called a procurement implementation. Fusion procurement implementation. You go to PTP. So on the Fusion procurement documentation, I'm going opening up the PTP process now. For double click on it, you're now opening the PTP process. PTP process, I'm opening it up. So what is the purpose of purchasing module? It is to basically optimize the spend. Right? Reduction of spend is the ultimate aim, but it's not possible. So spend reduction is not possible, but spend optimization is very much possible. So when you can optimize, only when you know how much you're spending. So we have to know how much you're spending. For which, what happened? The charge account is the one which is the indicator for how much you're spending. So in the procure to pay life cycle, what happens when you make a purchase order, no accounting is made actually. Accounting will not be made. So once when you make a gate receipt, the receiving inspection account is hit at the PO price. This exercise I used to do a long time back, some 10 years back on the EBIS basically. So I not modified this actually and keeping it up. And the standard costing I used to do. Okay. So receiving inspection will be at the PO price. The inventory price is 10, whereas the PO price is 10, 11. So it will be hitting at this one. So this is basically inspection receiving account mentioned in money, but quantity. It is basically inspection. How much has been inspected? 1,000 quantity has been inspected. The contra entry is accrual. Accrual is nothing but a notional liability. We are supposed to pay 11,000 rupees to the suppliers, but since it is not inspected and delivered, it is not eligible for a payment actually. So accrual is a notional liability. There are two types of accruals are there. One is an asset accrual, one is an expense accrual. Then afterwards, once when you deliver the item into the inventory, the inventory valuation account, the inventory material value account will be hit or for the financial side, and then the charge account will be hit from the purchasing side actually. So both accounts are simultaneously hit, inventory valuation as well as the charge account. Here I have not demonstrated on a standard costing. So in an average costing, what happens is there will not be any PPV at all. Everything will be hitting over here. And then the inventory, what happens, the receiving gets relieved. So after two stages of entry, gate entry and then the delivery or the put away, you will have the accrual to charge account will be the remaining accounts. Accrual to charge will be the remaining account from a purchasing perspective. And then accrual to inventory valuation from a financials perspective. We will not discuss about financials. This is basically a charge account. Accrual to charge account will be remaining. Now, once when you create an invoice by relieving the accrual, you're going to relieve the accrual. Then what happens, the accrual will be hit like this. And then let us say, now we are going to do here in the space, what happens, I will be normally creating the invoice, the price of the item as 13 now. So that what happens, I will be getting what? The IPV will be getting it. IPV will be getting it if the item price is more than the PO price now. That will happen mainly because of when you're going for a multiple currency. So let us say, I'm now using on GBP and then USD. Then because of currency fluctuations, the IPV will be, that is a normal one. But for demonstration purposes, I will now increase the price, then I will now show the IPV hitting a point. It is mainly because of currency fluctuations. Then he is asking for a freight. He is asking for miscellaneous expenses and then tax. And then put together, his invoice cost is 15,400. Fine. Now putting everything together. So here we are now getting the liability. Liability gets created because accrual is relieved by invoice. When the accrual gets relieved, then afterwards what happens, you'll be having the charge account to your liability will be the ultimate accounts which are there at stage three. Then afterwards what happens, we'll now go there. We are going to make a payment now. Fine. So once when the payment is processed, you'll now issue a check to the supplier now. So AP liability gets relieved and then the cash clearing will be hit now. Then afterwards, the supplier is now encashing the check by presenting it to the bank. And then the cash management module will now perform a bank reconciliation. And then there will be some clearing charges and other things are there. So that will be posted to the appropriate in either to supplier or to us. And then the cash clearing will be relieved. And then finally, the cash is in. So after five zones of activity, first two are in the your inventory, right? And then the third is in the AP now. Fine, third in the AP, and then the third and fourth are in the AP, and then finally fifth will be in the CM, cash management model. So once when the complete procure to pay life cycle is hit, the remaining entries for discussion are what? The charge account to cash account. So these are the only two entries which are now basically interest. So here, how much of charge account and then how much you have paid? Fine. Normally, what happens, it will be 10,000 and then you pay this much, but we will be discussing on the quantity based on this one. Charge, fine. 1,000 quantities have been, has been done, and then out of which you have now paid the cash, including so many miscellaneous things. So charge to cash is a very important one for the end client actually. And how the charge is going to be hit actually. There are five ways of hitting the charge account. So we have an asset item, we have an expense item. We'll now see what exactly is an asset item, what is an expense item. Fine. We'll open up. Have a look at it. So go to the two, and then I just made a document on this now. Open it up. We'll now see asset and expense classification. The 42nd document on your additional four is asset expense classification. Double click on it and open it up. We're opening it up. I'll go there. So here, material charge account varies for various asset and expense items are being transacted into asset and expense subunits. So there are two types of items. One is an asset item, one is an expense item. And then there are two types of subinventories on which you are performing a transaction. That is asset subinventory and expense subinventory. So in total, we'll be having five different types of charge account getting hit actually. So now what is an asset item? For example, I'm now going to build a monitor. I'm now going to put some bolts, nuts, washers, screws, and then many low-cost items using used for the finishing or manufacturing of the goods. So these low-cost items will be expense items. Let us say screw is 2 paisa. When you want to buy, you will now buy 1 lakh screws at 2 paisa, and then you have to pay the supplier basically. But cost will be zero actually, because it is a very low cost. Let us say I am not going to put 20 screws, fine, and then it is not going to cost me 4 rupees on the monitor building actually. So monitor has got picture tube and motherboard, and then if you sum up the cost, roll up the cost, it is 1,204 including the screw cost. So the main purpose of costing of a monitor is what? To derive the sale price. So sale price is going to what? Cost price multiplied by your margin or percentage or whatever it is, by an amount or whatever it is. So they derive the sale price by the cost price actually. So 1,204 multiplied by 20% will again give you some very strange value. So marketing department will now give a price of what? Let us say 1,299 to attract the customers. So they will not derive, once when the sales price is known from there, what happens, they will not derive how much they have to position. Fine. They should not go. There's a line which is now demarcated. 1,204 is the one. So below which you should not go. You will now try to sell it to 1,500. It is 1,499. And then if the competition goes up, they will now give a discount. All these things they will not do. Fine. So that the price will not go below the cost price. So that 4 rupees is very insignificant for calculation of the sale price. And so what happens, then these items will be made as an expense item. The expense item will not have any cost, but will have a price actually. But the screw manufacturing company, the washer manufacturing company, it is an asset item because they are manufacturing it. That is an asset item. Similarly, the cotton-based cleaning fluids, lubricating oils, and other items, which are now indirectly contributing towards the manufacturing of this part. Fine. So they will also be an expense item. Whereas in the actual manufacturing area, it is an asset item. The picture tube, motherboards, and other components which are having a significant cost will be an asset item in our company. In outside also, it will be an asset item. There is another example of a kerosene being used in burning the furnace. Fine. So kerosene is now going to be used for burning certain raw materials actually. Once again. So kerosene is now used for burning some raw materials, and so it will be asset item. So we are going to charge it to WIP actually. But we issue kerosene to a subinventory which is very near to the furnace, which is the maintenance subinventory, where we are using kerosene for lubricating it or cleaning it. We are doing it now. So this activity is known as what? Asset item is expensed out into expense of inventory. The cost of the expensed item when moved from the main sub-inventory to the maintenance sub-inventory. So it is basically, let us say I have 10,000 rupees worth of asset in the main, and then I have issued, let us say, 500 rupees of kerosene to the maintenance sub-inventory. 500 rupees expensed, and then the total company value will be 9,500 only. So we have 9,500 rupees worth of value of kerosene is only available. 500 rupees is no expense note. Whereas in the manufacturing area, it is another item. The scrap, you are having a lathing machine, and then you don't do the scrap gets generated. So if you see, you dump the scrap in the scrap yard, you will not know how much of scrap is there at all in the scrap yard. Fine, you cannot calculate it. So the scrap yard is basically a non-tracked expense of inventory. Fine, there's an expense, and then is a non-tracked means what? We cannot say how much of scrap is there. But if you put a scrap on a sales order, sales orders will not have any charge account at all. Fine, no charge account. All asset and expense item will be sold, and then they will be hitting a cost of goods sold account. And from that, what happens, it will now go into revenue recognition and other areas of AR actually. So the charge account is applicable only for purchasing actually. And there are five means of doing it actually. The charge account calculation will find out. So we have got two types of items, and then two types of sub-inventories, and then we will now go and then do this exercise. Any doubts, any clarifications on this one?
I have one question.
Tell me.
Suppose we are buying a kerosene oil.
Yeah.
And we have created a sub-inventory.
First, so receiving it in the main sub-inventory, kerosene.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
1,000 liters at 10 rupees, 10,000 rupees worth of kerosene is available in the main sub-inventory. Yeah, tell me.
So whenever we are creating sub-inventory infusion, so you have seen that...
Hello, your voice is breaking. I'm unable to hear you. Hello.
For purchase order, we have charge account. And for sales order, you say there is a COGS account. So already cost is being calculated, cost of raw materials, which is being put up for manufacturing the end product.
Yeah.
We are calculating it in the purchase order as a charge account.
Yeah.
So what is the use of this COGS account in sales order?
COGS account is mainly for sales actually. So once when you know your sale price is, let us say, 10,000 rupees, your COGS account is 8,000. So what is the margin you are earning? 2,000 rupees margin. So what happens, the different sales executives will be given different margins. Fine, I'm a manager. So I can sell at a margin of around 10%, whereas a junior person can sell only at a margin of 20% because he's a junior guy. Whereas as a manager, I can even bring in volume sales. So management will be giving me the Oracle sales. Fine. You can even work on a 10% margin. Even GMs can be given a 5% margin also. In some cases, whenever you go and then negotiate a price, you know what the sales executive will do? Sir, wait a minute, I will now go inside and then talk. This guy will now go to the talk on the manager because he will not be eligible to give the discount. So his manager will ask about my details and all. Fine, okay, I'll do. Fine. Then what happens? This guy will now log into the manager's account. So once when he gives a login of the manager account, it will be allowing him to give a higher discount actually. In some places you can see. Sir, wait a minute, I will not go talk to my managers. So he will now log in into the system with his manager's account, and then he will now sell the product. And then the manager will invariably give the bonus or whatever, maybe the commission will be passed on to him. He will now give it to you. So to encourage these people, they pass on the commissions to the lower level executives. So to calculate the margin, the COGS is very, very important. Sales minus cost is the margin actually.
Okay.
So coming back to my question. So
make it fast.
Yeah. Asset item as a kerosene is an asset item.
Okay.
So in whenever that expense of inventory would be created in the same sub-inventory, managed sub-inventories, because there it asset sub-inventory is only visible.
No, I'm going to create expense sub-inventory. Now, fine, don't worry. I'll be getting it. Don't worry.
Fine.
I'll be getting it. That is your question. Fine. Why you are not creating expense? I'll be creating it. Okay.
I have not seen an expense of inventory.
No, I'm going to create it. Don't worry.
Nana, when you are issuing any material to expense of inventory, the value has been gone, but the on end
cost is gone, not the value. Remember, the cost is gone. When you issue it out, the cost is gone, but the price is there, etc. There is no value. There is no what happens. It will not vanish. The price will not vanish. The only the cost will vanish.
No, Nana. Say suppose there are 10 buckets in my hand. So, and these values of 1,000 rupees, when I'm issuing it to the expense item, the 1,000 cost will be booked in my GL, but the 10 quantity should remain in the inventory, the without value, or that is also
without value. See, financial accounting, nothing is lost actually. The 1,000 rupees is there in the main. If you issue 100 rupees over here, financial accounting will now calculate 900 plus 100 only. Whereas cost accounting will calculate as 900 plus 0. Cost accounting calculation is different from financial accounting number. Financial accounting, everything is there in the company only. The purpose of cost accounting is to what? Decide the selling price actually. You are expensing it out. Okay, fine. So now we are now going to do the 5 different ways of charging the charge account. So we got to say this. So we have seen about the asset and expense classification, and then I'm going to create expense subinventory also. Fine with that. We are now going to see 5 different ways of what happens creating the charge account. Any doubts on this? First of all, this screen, asset and expense item classification. Is it clear now?
Sir, one doubt. In general, like kerosene, we'll be using water also in most of the industries. So yeah, how do we place water?
If you pay money for water, then it will be an asset item. If you're getting it free, then it will not be considered at all. The cost price will be zero actually. Suppose, let us say, one tanker lorry, you're buying it at 250 rupees for, let us say, 5,000 liters. So 5,000 liters cost is 250 rupees. Okay. If you're buying it free, if something somebody is giving you, you'll now make the cost as zero.
Nana, is it possible to maintain an on-hand stock for an expense item?
Yes, of course, naturally. You see, I have what happens, let us say, the washer or something like that is there. So we can even have an on-hand. But many times, the expense items will not be tracked. Right? Expense items will be kept on a non-tracked sub-inventory. Right?
Will be in packets.
Yeah, no. It may not be. See, when the fitter is coming in and then walking into the expense subinventory where you have kept the bolts, nuts and washers, he will now put his hand and whatever comes in the hand, he will now take it up and then go away. So that is called bulk issue to the manufacturing. So those are all non-tracked subinventories actually. The normally expense items will be kept on a non-tracked only. In very strange cases, you will be keeping it on a tracked also.
No, maintaining
this can be connected in cycle count.
Of course. If it is a tracked, you can even go for cycle counting also.
So, Nana, you are saying if some item you use directly only, then it will be asset like kerosene
oil. Not necessarily. The screw is now used directly for manufacturing.
No, I'm just saying, I understood that. Kerosene, like we are using for burning the furnace.
And
if office items like
are not going to be
directly used. Right. Okay.
Got it? So now we will now go there and then we will now begin our activity on this. How to do the charge accounting calculation? We will now see, first of all, in e-biz now. We'll now go on and have a look at the e-biz.
If it is non-tracked, then they will buy in bulk. What about if it is go out of stock and it will affect the manufacturing, right?
Yeah. There are 3 techniques are available here. One is a periodic automatic replenishment. One is a replenishment counting. One is a Kanban replenishment. All the 3 are unfortunately using wrist and postman services. I don't know how to do it now. So please watch how to replenish it in eBiz now. And eBiz, I have fully explained in my eBiz records. It's all there now. But I'm unable to do it on Fusion because I don't know these technical topics at all. I don't know even how to install REST and Postman.
Is those 3 are for expense item replenishment?
No. Asset item also. Not necessarily expense. Anything can be replenished. Fine. Expense and asset are only for costing purposes, not for physical replenishment. Physical replenishment will not consider only quantity replenishment.
Sir, it is available for EBS in your documents?
Yeah. I already told you, fine. Watch all my records. I don't know where I have kept it. Anybody remember it? In my INVPO records?
INVPO records.
INVPO records, it is there somewhere. Fine, go there. I have forgotten where exactly I have kept my EBS.
You have given a Word document.
Ah, okay, fine, go there. Yeah. Please read each and everything now, fine. Then only you will be understanding. Inventory, yeah. Inventory control characteristics. I don't know which one it is. No, fine. One of the thing will be having the inventory records actually. Fine. That will be having a link. The eBiz inventory records. There's 25. 25 is eBiz inventory records. Watch my record. Download them first of all. And then there you can see all the replenishment techniques. All the 5 replenishment techniques are demoed in eBiz now basically. Please watch it. 25th one.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
But I don't know how to do it in Fusion. Good. Fine with that. Now we'll now go there, go to this place, and then we will now go to Fusion inventory documentation, and then we'll now have one asset expense item. In the Fusion inventory documentation, we have one asset expense items. We are going to begin with that, and then afterwards we will now move into Fusion. Double click on it. asset expense item on Fusion inventory documentation below your procurement. Okay, open the asset expense item. I'm going to open up. So I'm now opening it up. So first, let me create one asset item and one expense item. I will locate one asset item and one expense item. I'm going to that. We will locate an asset item and expense item. So I'm now inventory. If I go to the items and then go to the master items now. So double click on it. I go to items and master items and then let me create an asset and expense item. Go there. So I'm in V1 organization. I will now say J05_asset-item. And go there. I will now take a copy of it and then put it in the description now. And then I will go to the tools and then I go to the copy from. Fine. Let me copy from a template now. Fine. Those who don't know EBIS, just watch. Fine. No need not to worry at all. Fine. And then click on that now. Fine. I'm now applied. And then I will now go to the purchasing and then I will now give a list price. And there's already list prices available. Fine. Go there. Fine. Go there. Fine. Go there. Commit. Control is commit. So you're saving it and then you're going to assign it. Then the unit submitted, there's a clash actually. Fine. I will now choose the EA. Fine. Each somebody is now doing an R&D. It is an unupdatable attribute both in EBIS and Fusion. Fine. Once when it is saved, you cannot update it at all. It's unable to find that. Go to the tools, and then I go to the organization assignment. Let me assign it to M1 now. So go with that. I will now assign it. So go to query mode, and then I will now put M1, and then query it now. Fine. Let me assign it. It's assigned. Fine. Coming. M1 Seattle. So in Fusion, it is known as 001 Seattle. Here it is known as M1. Fine. Transactions complete. Fine. That. I will now make a change organization over here now. Fine. Go to the place. I will change the organization. Let me bring it to the right hand side. Let me change my organization 1 to M1 now, so that it will not be having any problem at all in future. So please mute your mics now. Right? So now we will now create an expense item also. I will now create an expense item. Go to the items and then go to the master items. So we are now going to create an expense item now. Double click on it. Let us now create an expense item. So I will now say J05. _expense-item. Go there. So take a copy of it and then put on this place now. So it's expense item. And then I will now go to the tools and then I will now go to the copy from and then I will now apply a template. PUR is a template. Purchase template. I'm applying it. Okay, now. Then click on that now. Again, the units of measure problem will be coming when I commit. Before I commit, what happens? I go to the costing area and then if you remove the inventory asset value, it becomes an expense item. It is true in both Fusion and EBIS basically. If inventory asset value is off, what happens? It will be an expense item. Whereas it is an inventory item. Fine, go there, click on the inventory. So inventory is enabled and then costing is disabled. Fine, it is an inventory expense, remember. It is an inventory expense. Fine, go to the commit. So it will give a problem on this one. Fine, click on OK now, fine, commit. That's it. So the expense item is now created. Fine, go to the main now, fine, it's not done. So it is an inventory expense, the costing, the inventory value, asset value is all. Fine, go to that one. I will now go to the tools and then I go to the assignment. Fine, go to the organization assignment, it will be assigned it. It's all same in Fusion and EBIS. Commit, control is commit. So we now created two expense items. So we are not dead. Fine. We'll now go there. We will now create two sub-inventories. One is an asset sub-inventory, one is an expense sub-inventory. Fine. Asset sub-inventory and expense sub-inventory. Stores is already an asset. Let me create only an expense sub-inventory. Fine. Take a copy. Let me go and then create an expense sub-inventory. Fine. Collapse all. Fine. SOS and then enter in now. And then control F11 and retrieve. All the things will be coming. All the sub-inventories are going to come. And control down arrow. I will now paste this expense sub-inventory. I'm not creating an expense sub-inventory. So while I'm creating an expense sub-inventory, I'm now going to give an expense account also on this one. So sub-inventory is expense account. I will not take a copy of it now. Fine. Expense sub-inventory, I'm creating it. Fine, go there. I will not drag it to the expense area. Click on it. So here, you will now have what happens, your expense account. So I will now go there. I will now, let me paste it over here. This is the account, I'm pasting it. And commit, control is commit. It is not a, so 03520-7530-110. That is the expense account on the expense account. Similarly, on the stores also, you'll be having an expense account. Let me take a copy of this now, expense account. And then I'll let me query the stores now. Fine. Go to the query mode. And then I will now query the core stores now. Fine. STO percentage. And then let me query it now. So store sub-inventory is an asset sub-inventory. Expense account is this one now. Paste it over here. 7520. Fine. Simulation, I'm not doing it. Fine. You can know, also do simulations in a different manner. So 7520 is the one. So the store sub-inventory is have an expense account. The expense sub-inventory is have an expense account. Let us now start to transact. Now make a transaction and the item will be having an expense account like this one. Let us now set up the items account on this now. Fine, go there. So items account is what? This is the expense account of an item actually. So go there, close it now. So you know, we'll query the item now. Fine, go there. So once when the item is assigned, we have to go to items and then go to organization items and then query it now. Fine, go to the organization items and then query the item. Let me query the J05 expense item and then let me set up the expense account of this now. Fine, go there. J05 and then give it a both asset and expense will be coming now. Fine, click on OK now. So I will now get expense item bank code. I click on it, query it. I click on fine now. So I'm going to set up the expense item of an account in the order controlled area, fine, in the organization item. We don't have an organization item in Fusion actually. And go there. So I will now go to the purchasing, and then I will now set up the expense account. Paste it over here. 02520-7530. Fine, that is what it is. That is the expense account. Go there. So in the items are 02520-7530 and then ending in 260. And everything is now set. Let us now create a purchase order and then have a look at it. So let us now switch responsibility to purchasing. And then here, I'm now going to get a purchase order. So purchasing vision operations USA is the one. There, let me get a purchase order. So go there, go down. So the purchase orders, double click on it. Doing things in Fusion, EBIS is very fast actually. Fusion is somewhat slow actually. So go to the purchase orders. Let me create a purchase order for this. So there are five situations by which the charge account can be populated now. We are going to go for the first one now. Fine. I have one ready-made supplier called Advanced Network Devices. Fine, go there. I will now put the site as a press now. Fine, go there. Click on it. I will now put my item over here now. Item is what? J05 asset item. I'm going to put it. J05 asset item I'm populating on this. So it is going to a price of 27 that will be coming automatically. Okay, price has got changed because of you'll be having the reference document, you'll be having a contract also available. So because of it, the price has got automatically changed. Doesn't matter if I go there. I will now go for quantities. And then go to the shipments. Click on the shipments and then the purchase order, whatever they go there. The UAM is giving a problem. Somebody said. So here I will now say in the distribution area, shipments area, the organization, the shipped location, the quantity, and then the need be date or promise date. One of them is a mandatory. Fine, go there. I will not put one of the dates. Okay. All the four are mandatory. Or location, quantity, and dates. Fine. Everything is not done. I go to the distribution. Click on the distribution. In the distribution, I go there. And then in this place, what I'm going to do is I'm now going to transact on the asset account. Fine. Go to the more now. I'm going to the distribution. I go to the more. I'm going to click on it. So go there. So here I will now put the what's called destination. Sub-inventory I'm going to put. So go there. I will now say in which one I'm going to transact now. I'm going to transact this asset item under an asset sub-inventory called stores. So once when I do it, what happens? It will now pick up the material charge account from organization parameters actually. From the organization parameter, it will now pick up and then populate this as a pure charge account. Fine. It is an asset sub-inventory. Asset item into an asset sub-inventory. Fine, go there. Both are on now. Quantity tracked and asset sub-inventory are on. Fine, go there. When you do it, the material account in the organization parameter will be the charge account over there. Go there, click on it. I will now put stores over here. And go there. I will now put stores over here. Enter it. And go there. Give a commit. Address commit. You can now see the PO charge account will be 011410 will be the account which will be the charge account for this scenario now. So 1410. I will now show you this account on the organization parameter 1410. I will now show you. I will now show you later on. So when you transact asset item into asset subinventory, this is the first type of charging. There are five ways of charging. Now, if an asset item is charged into an expense account, the expense account will be the charge account. Let me change it to expense subinventory. Expense subinventory has got an expense account. So that becomes a charge account and not this 1410. I will not change it to what expense subinventory. I will now go there. EXP and then give a tab. Expense subinventory. I'm going to put it. Once when you commit it, what happens if you give a commit? Let's commit. The account gets changed from 1410 to the expense subinventory is the expense account. Let's commit. Oh God, it is not changing. No changes to save.
No, sir, it will not save. No change. No, because it's an inventory item. You're not doing an expense item.
No, inventory only. Inventory item into an expense subinventory.
It's an inventory item. If you go to an expense subinventory also, it will get charged to the material account.
No.
So you are still in stores, I believe.
Maybe, yeah, something has gone. One second, let me go there, close it. Let me re-query the purchase order now. Fine, go there. So it is not coming.
No, it will get changed only after you deliver it to that expense subinventory.
No. Itself, the purchase order itself will not change. No, re-query it now. Fine, go there. No, re-query. So go there. Go to the shipments. I go there. Go to the distributions now. Fine. It will get changed. It is not getting changed at all.
I think you have mentioned that item as an inventory, not as an expense.
One second, I have forgotten. I have made one mistake actually.
Sir, saved. You saved it, no, sir. Once no, saved, it cannot be changed.
No. I made a mistake here. Let me go to inventory now. Fine. I made a mistake here. I only created an expense of inventory, but I have not made it as a real expense actually. There is a mistake actually. I will now go to SOS now. Fine. Go to SOS and then query for it now. Fine. SOS is
cities are not.
I have not made the change at all. Buddha over here, forgetting things actually. I will now go to query mode, and then I will now go for expense now. Expense percentage is query now. So I made the expense, fine, go there, click on it, and then I have not made a change here now. Fine, I have not removed the asset now. Then only it will become expense now. Fine. Now only it will now become expense. This tick mark has to be removed now. Fine, expense immediately. If you go and then go to the register office and register my name as an intelligent Nana, I will not behave like an intelligent Nana. I will not continue to behave only a foolish Nana only. Fine. I have to behave. So expense inventory, the tick mark is not removed. It will know assets sub inventory only. Fine. That is the problem. Go there. Go to the purchasing and then we will now query the purchase order now. So go to the visions and then go there. This time what happens if you query it? I will now go to the purchase orders and then just query it now. Go to the meet. Fine. Go to the query mode. Go there, paste it, and then click on query the record, and then now you go to the shipments, and then go there, go to the distributions now, fine, go there. So here I will now go to this place, and then change it to what stores now, fine, stores, give a tab, and then commit now. Now I will now change it to expense, exp, and then give a tab, expense have been not defined, click on okay now, fine, and then commit, plus commit. Now you can see the charge account getting changed actually. It is now 03520 7530 and then 110. So this is the one. So expense accounts, expense sub inventory, expense charge account becomes this. Now let me add an expense item directly. Fine, I will now add the second line.
I have one question, sir. See, the charge account coming from the organization
Tapsi, please mute it. No, fine. When you're talking, please mute it. Now let me add the second line. So J05, and then give a tap. I'm now going to put what? Okay. J05 percentage and then enter now. So let me put the expense item again. Now. I'm putting it over there. I will now go for 200 quantities now. I will now go to the shipments and then I go to the distributions. Click on OK now. And then you go to the distributions. Now I'm not putting any sub inventory at all. Oh, this is required. So one of the dates. So all the four informations are required. Organization, shift location, quantity, and dates. Fine with that. So if you don't do it, it will not come. In EBIS also, infusion also the same thing. Fine, click on distribution now. Okay. Now, if you don't put anything, fine, go there. The items expense account becomes a charge account. And then that will be overridden when you're receiving it, remember. When you're receiving it, it will be overridden again. But the PO line will be showing you what in the destination, what happens, you go there. So if you commit it, what happens, items account will become the charge account. So it will get overridden during receiving, remember. So item has got 02520 and all. Fine, go there. If you commit it, that will be the charge account. The charge account will be items expense account. Items. This was not working in Fusion actually. Fine. We were having a lot of problems. And then we raised the SR. I don't know. I have not checked it. So after 1 year's time, I'm checking it. Fine, we'll now see whether the items account is coming as a charge account or not in Fusion. We are going to make a check of it. Is it clear now? Items account becomes a charge account. If you put any sub-inventory, that sub-inventory is expense account will now become a charge account. If you don't put any sub-inventory, items expense account becomes a charge account. I go there. 02 and then 260 is ending. And I put the stores. Stores, expense item, expense account is this. That will become a charge account. I will now go there. Sub-inventory is stores. During receiving, it will now get overridden. Remember, receiving will be overriding the account again. Countless commit. And then you can see. The stores one is what? 70 and then 7530. 70 and 7530 is the one. This is the charge account. Right. So if no sub-inventory is present on the purchase order, then items expense account will become a charge account for expense items. This was having a bug in Fusion, and then I think they might have corrected it. We are going to check it today itself. We'll not check it now. The expense diagram is now coming as a charge account or not. We are going to make a check. Then what happens? The next one is what? The expense item into an expense sub-inventory. Fine. Expense item. If you change the expense, whatever sub inventory you put, asset or expense, its expense account will now become the charge account now, as far as expense items are concerned. So if you put the expense item, it is 03520 will be coming now. So I will not change it. We will change it to 03. Fine. Go there. Click on it. Expense and then give it app now. Expense sub inventory. Okay. Okay. Now. Control S commit. Now it will be 03520. 03520. So there is one. So these are the four methods of charging the charge account. Asset into expense into asset, and then expense into expense. The fifth one is service item actually. Where what happens, we are now going to buy what? The welding, special cutting, AMC, etc. Fine, we'll be having a description based purchase. So once when you have a description based purchase, there is basically category based purchase. Fine. If the inventory, you're having this now, fine. If you go there, if inventory itself is off, then it is known as what? Either fixed assets or enterprise assets. Inventory is off, whereas the inventory asset value is on. inventory asset value is on. If this is off and this is on, then they are not going to fix assets enterprises like what happens. You'll be having the plant, building, machinery, etc. Everything will be coming under fixed assets. And then enterprise assets are basically your cutting machine, lathe machine, your boiler, etc. will be coming under enterprise assets actually. Right. So enterprise assets are now calculated on maintenance management actually in Fusion. Right. We have one more girl who is working on maintenance management, and then she's struggling like anything. And then Surya is also knowing maintenance management. Surya knows maintenance management. If you are going to work on manufacturing or maintenance management, contact that girl as well as Surya also. Fine. They are all working on these two modules. If anybody else is also working, I think Anand is also working on maintenance, isn't it? Anand is also working on maintenance. So there are these are people who will be who can be contacted.
First. Maintenance comes under manufacturing umbrella or how?
Yeah, manufacturing and maintenance. Manufacturing and maintenance are two modules basically. Right. That is a separate module, but they are all closely linked with each other actually. Now we'll now go for service items, which is a description based. Now, when the AMC service is now being requested by one requester, so every requester will be having a charge account, and then that becomes a material charge account. Now, what I'm going to do is I will now create one now. Fine, so I am now logged in now. Fine. So let me go there, go to HRMS now. Fine. Switch responsibility human resources now. I'm now switching responsibility human resources, and then I'm going to provide go to people, and then go to enter maintain. I'm not going to provide a charge account for me because I am the person who has logged in now. Fine. The name is what? Ananta2. And then give it Ananta2, Nana2. Nana2, last name, comma, first name. Last name, comma, first name. I'm going to find it. Ananta Nana is the one. I'm going to provide a charge account for myself now. I'm now going to request for what? Some item now. Fine. Some services actually. I will not go to the assignment now. Fine. Click on the assignments and then go there. So in the assignments, what I'm going to do is I will now go to the place, and then in the assignments area, I go there, go down, and then go to the purchase order information now. Fine, go there. I will now put a default account over there. I will now populate some account over here and no account now. So default expense account, I'm going to charge it. Go there, drop it down. And then I use the 01 company, fine, go there, control L. Default expense account is not coming. And we'll take it up from this place now. Some account will not take it up, and then we'll now modify this now. Give a tap. So go to this place. And then here I will now modify this. Don't put 03 because it is now a different company actually. Fine. You use 01 now. Fine. 01 will be good now. So I will now say 01. Okay, fine. I will now commit it. Different account, fine. It's a default expense account. So this account becomes a charge account because I am asking for AMC service actually.
Nana, entry is not saved. Can you please reopen the form?
No changes to save. Oh God. Go there. Click on the assignment now. Fine. Entry is not saved at all. So God, why so?
Nana, can you please enter the ledger? After that, maybe it will pick.
No, first of all, save it now. Fine, control is commit. See, no changes to save the thing now. Come on, why it is not coming now? There is no default expense account is not a queryable one now.
Nana, can you please enter the ledger?
Oh, ho, 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 ho. Very correct, very correct. Fine. Enter, very correct. I'm not going to enter the ledger actually. Fine, go there. I will now perform a correction now. Ledger is not entered. There is a reason now. Correct, correct, correct. Good, good, good. So go there. So go there. Good, good, good observation of that. I will now make a change to what? This one is 01 now. 01 because 03 belongs to some other company. And then I will now change the product value to something else. Product value. I will now say 114 now. Click on again. So remember, it is now starting on 01 and then ending on 114 now. So once when I order for AMC, and then we have to, the purchase officer will now populate who is the requester actually. And then 01114 will be coming. 01114 will be coming if the purchase officer populates. Now I'm having everything as the same name now, fine, because I cannot get any multiple users over here now, fine. I will now switch responsibility to purchasing. I come back to purchasing. Let me get a new purchase order now. Oh, no. Come out of it. And then switch responsibility to purchasing now. I go there. So I come to the purchasing mission operations now. So let me get a new purchase order now, fine. Number one, only the purchase order is now getting created now. Go there. Supplier is what? Advanced network devices. Go there. Site is what? Fresno. Go there. So type is what? It is no more goods actually. Fine. Go there. So there are two types of line types are available here. One is what? Quantity based. One is amount based actually. So let me go to what the what's called the amount based basically. I will now see consulting. Consulting is an amount based. So quantity based is basically different one. Amount based is basically description based, category based basically. amount based or description based.
Sir, but a service item cannot be stockable, no? It cannot cannot have that stockable. So how can be it as a
quantity-based? Who says that it is going to be stockable? Consulting services, I'm not going to stock.
And how come it comes as quantity? A quantification will come only if there's a physical stock, isn't it?
Yeah, see, I'm now going to give you, let us say AMC now, fine, whether I will not say this one. So the description is what? AMC per quarter. Quarter. The quantity is 5 quarters. I'm going to give it now. Got it now? Fine. The 5 quarters. 5 quarters of AMC now. Fine. The AMC. So it can be even quantified actually. Let us say cable laying. I will now say unit submitted is kilometers, and then I will now say 2 kilometers. Got it now? Fine. It can be. So let me put one of the categories now. Fine. So MISC dot MISC and miscellaneous miscellaneous. So the description and category based, whenever you are going to be amount based, take you if it is amount based. Now the purchase officer is now going to create a purchase order for AMC, and then who is the requester, you will not see. You will not go there. So what he is going to do, you will not go there. You go to the shipments, and then he will not say who is requesting it. He will not go to the distributions, and then he will not put the requester's name over here now. So I will not choose M1 serial manufacturing test now. What is M1? So he will now put the requester's name. I am the guy who is requesting it. So my charge account will be the PO charge account. He will now put what Nana 2 has asked for it. Give it that. This guy has asked for it. So whomsoever the requester name, he will now put on this and then go there and then commit it. Whatever the charge account will be ending in 114. No, fine, control is commit. You can also see the charge account ending in 114 will be coming. So material charge account will be charged against the employee's expense account. And then tomorrow, whenever they are monitoring it, which employee has asked for this, that person's account will be charged. And then they know all the employees charge account. And then let us say how many AMCs I am asking for 1 month or 1 year or one quarter. I can very well take a report. And then the management will be questioning me later on. Hey, you have spent this much of money for AMC alone. What is this? So they can very well optimize the spend, basically. Spend optimization happens for an expense one now. Right? So the requester's expense account becomes the charge account for this now. For category-based, description-based, remember. For a category-based, description-based. Got it now, fine. Now, we had one more requirement. Came in Fusion now, fine. We struggled like anything, and then we did some jugra, some here and there. We used a tab and tab to do this now. So now, what happens? They wanted to change, fine. What happens? For a particular category, they want to have different segments having different values actually. So this is a famous requirement. I don't know how to do it. Fine, go there. I will now go to the Fusion also and then do it now. Fine. So I want to override the segments based upon the category now. I want to override the segments based upon the category. And this is what is going to call it. I'm going to do it. So this is very easy in Fusion. EVS, whereas it's very difficult. We struggle like anything. And then I will now show you. But probably that may be working now. Fine. I'm not sure about it. Fine, go that point. So
there's no Nana in Fusion, it is possible.
Fusion is possible, but I was struggling like anything. I will show you where exactly it's struggling. And then if it has come, that will be nice actually. It was having a bug previously. I will tell you.
No, it is working.
It's working. Yeah, fine. Very good, very good. If it is working, it's excellent. Now, fine. If it is working. Previously, what happens? I am unable to do this also. Fine. Now, I am going to see based upon this category. Fine. MISC, if you put it, what happens? I would like to have these are the categories to come up. Now, fine. The segments of segment wise override is very much possible in EBS very easily. I can go there. So I will now go to what tools and then I will go to the navigator now. Fine. So I will now go to what tools, where is the thing here? How to go to navigator? I forgot on that now. Come on. How to go to the navigator? I come on. Click on the navigator.
Actions.
Go to the
Windows.
Windows. Close other forms now. Fine. Close other forms. I'm removing it now. Fine.
Go to Windows, Nana.
Okay, fine. Go to Windows. Windows. Windows I can close it now. Fine. Okay. Windows navigator.
Third icon can go.
Yeah, okay. Windows navigate. Okay. I'll take a copy. Let me put it on the Word file. Now, fine, go that on it. Number also, I'll put it on it. On it. So, the one. So, here I go there. And then in this place, I'm going to change this now. I will now go to the setups. And then I go to the financials. And then I go to the accounting. go to the accounting. And then here we have an expense override account. This is an excellent rule which we used very easily, actually. It's a child's play in EBIS now. Go there. Now our Vinay is saying that it is working in Fusion also. That will be, if it is working, it will be great actually. Fine, go there. Expense account rules, fine, go there. Double click on it. Now go and then populate the expense account over here. Go there. So let me create a one. So click on create. So it is basically available only for category. There is description based, category based, amount based. Line type is amount based. Fine. Only for that it is available, not for quantity based. So account rule value. Fine. Go that. I will not say misc. MISC dot. Then your tab. No. I will not choose misc itself. Go that. I will not choose misc. And quick select it. Go that. And then I will now modify the last product value. No. There is 114 now. I now will override it. Fine. That you want. Let me override it. So click on go now. So many values. So 114 I have given. I will now put 120 instead of 114 now. And quick select it. So if the category is going to be misc, then what happens? I will not, will have what the product segment is going to be 120. Likewise, any segment can be modified for any categories actually. That's it. It's done now. We are going to make a check of it now. So go there. I will now go to us. I will now go to and then make a check now. Now go there. Click on it. So let me it has to change to 120 now. Fine. We will not trigger the change actually by making a change of the quantity now. So 6 and then give a tab and then give a commit whether it is now becoming 11120 or not. Fine. Let's commit now. Fine. Change it. It is not becoming on it. It is not giving. So I have now saved it. Now fine. Transaction is complete. Let me re-query the purchase order. Now, fine. So whether it becomes 120 or not. Fine. Go to the query mode and then go there. There is no re-query the purchase order. So once we re-query the purchase order, it is still there. Let me add a new line on this. Now we'll see whether it works or not. Go there. It's shift FI. I am now putting the same value over here. Now fine. I will now say shift FI. Go there. I will now say test 2. Now find some other description. Fine. Go that you want it. And then I have a value now. I will now say it is 4 now. If you commit it, it has to be 120 now. Can't just commit now. It has to be 120 over here. Hold the space. See. Now it has become 120. Why this has not become 120?
No, sir. I think maybe for the old one, it has given 0.
Oh, it is already applied. And then maybe it may be prospective.
Yes, because you have created rule after that, right?
Another charge account will be generated one time.
See, Vinay is saying that the charge account will not be getting replaced now, for the expense account. It is not getting replaced. Okay. So this sort of a change was very difficult in Fusion for us. I will tell you about what the workaround we have made now. Fine, we created our tab and tad, and then we created a category based charge account now. Fine, that is not correct. So he's saying now it's working. So we are going to test it up in Fusion also. EBS is very flexible and very
powerful. Nana, I have worked on the SLA part and it is working. But for this kind of rule. Expense rule, I have not worked.
No, if you have what happens, SLA, it's okay. SLA is a different one. You can set up everything in SLA. But in case if you don't have an SLA, there's a ready-made solution available without SLA also in EBS basically. Got it? So now we are going to see this in Fusion now. Any doubts on this now? Fine. So there are 5 ways of charging now. Fine. There are 5 ways of charging.
Fine. Now one question. If for the expense item, when we are... expense inventory item, when we are issuing to the expense of inventory, yeah. The value of that item has been gone.
Yes, but cost is gone,
but the on end value is remaining in the inventory. Now,
let us say I have main sub inventory 1,000 rupees worth of item. I have issued 100 to an expense sub inventory, so main sub inventory will now come down to 900. Expense sub inventory will now still have a value of 0 only. Previously, also 0, now also 0.
Nana, but the concern is that suppose we have 100 quantities, yeah, with 10 rupees, the total values of the, when I am issuing it, the example 5 quantities to, yeah, expense of inventory.
Yeah.
My 500 cost has been gone.
Yeah. But but we have 10 available there. Main 5 and then the expense of inventory 5, quantity is 10 actually. But the cost of 5 is gone.
Yeah, I just want to confirm the quantity remain as it is.
Quantity will remain as it is, as long as it is a tracked sub inventory. If it is a non-tracked sub inventory, that 5 is also gone. If you are issuing it a non-tracked sub-inventory, then that 5 item also is gone. If it is a tracked one, it is there.
Okay, Nana.
Let us say, in a stationery shop, I have a stationery shop where I am now keeping papers now, fine? So 5 reams of paper are there, fine? Let us say, when I go there physically accounted, 5 reams of paper are there, fine? Go there. Now I purchased 2 reams now. Now tell me, this stationery sub-inventory will now show me how much of stock. When I counted, I found 5. When I received from the purchase order, I can very well receive it in the non-tracked expense. It is a non-tracked expense. Two reams of stationery have been received now. Now, how much the system will now show as a stock? Tell me. Anybody? 5 reams are already there. When I made a physical count, I found 5. I made a purchase order receipt of 2 now. Fine. How much the system will now show? No.
5. No.
No. 100% correct. Who is this now?
Jairaj.
Huh?
Jairaj.
Jayaraj is very, very correct. It will not show zero stock only. Previously also is zero stock. After you receive the two reams, then also it is zero stock, but it is non-tracking. Got it now, fine. Jayaraj is very 100% correct now. So you only physically counted, but system was showing only zero. When you receive two, then also it will not show zero. So remember how they are all functioning. It's again a big topic. We cannot discuss this in a great distance, great detail in this place, in this training, now fine for that. So that is
Nana, one more question, Nana. Tell me, yeah. Like in EBs for the fixed asset items, capital items.
Yeah, yeah.
You used to give the FA control account as in place of the expense account.
Mm-hmm. I don't know about FA.
Okay.
So anybody who knows FA, you can discuss with them actually.
We have Nana.
People who are their finance, and then they can discuss them. Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
Yeah, if you receive expense item into expense sub inventory,
yeah.
I have one account at item level and another account at expense sub inventory level. Which account will default?
We will see that. Now, fine, we are going to see this in Fusion actually. Fine, how different accounts are getting defaulted. Fine, so we have now seen asset into asset, asset into expense, expense into an asset, expense into an expense, and then service item. These are the five ones, and then we are going to see all the five in Fusion now. Here, it is a pointer actually. It says 1410. If you see this now, fine. 1410 is coming from this place actually. If you go on and close it now, fine. 1410 will be coming from this place. I will not go to the what? I will not go switch responsibility inventory now. I will not go to the inventory. Inventory vision operations. I go there. Click on it. And then I go to what? Setup organization parameters. I go to the setup organization parameters. And then here you have the accounts now. If you go there, go for M1 now. M1 organization. I click on OK now. So here we'll be having an account. So this becomes the charge account for an asset item now. If we go to the costing, fine. This becomes the charge account for an asset item. So we have seen on the sub-inventory level different of an accounts. Fine, that. And then if you go to the last average, we'll be having an account now. We'll be having what? The invoice place variance account, invoice AP account, everything is there. Fine. So here, there is no accounting at all in EVs now. In Fusion, there is no accounting at all. No accounts are entered at the organization level at all. Everything is in the costing level only. So here it picks up automatically. Here, the thing, whatever we have seen here, now fine, everything is basically a pointer actually. It points to this now. It points to this. It points to this. When you translate it, it points to this now. Fine. It comes, picks up automatically. In Fusion, it is not so. We have to set everything manually now. Fine. We have to set up everything manually. That is a very cumbersome part. But Oracle says that that flexibility is required. That is what they say now. Fine. Removing it. Nothing. Here, accounting is perpetual. As and when you transact it, the account gets created. The distribution gets created. But in Fusion, it is not so. No distributions are created upon completion of any transaction in inventory. So in either doubt, we are going to jump into Fusion now. Fine, for accounting, it's somewhat tough actually. It is so easy in EBIS, but it is not so easy in Fusion actually. It's somewhat tough.
You have to tell that it is easy. And so all will be good.
Go there. Let me stop the record at this stage. Any doubts at this stage now? So we are going to jump into the toughest part of this one, fine. Accounting, purchasing accounting in Fusion actually. So I will go for a cup of coffee and then I will come back at 7 o'clock now. So you can discuss amongst you. Okay. Bye for now and then I will come back. Hi, welcome back. And then we have just completed the e-business purchasing accounting. We are now going to see Fusion purchasing accounting. We have implemented a project in Muscat where a company is basically a builder actually. He is building very many houses throughout Muscat actually. So every house he is constructing is a project actually. We have sold a project to him, and then every house is a project. And then he issues very many materials to every house. Say for example, in Annanagar I have a house, in Egmore we have a house, he is now constructing it. So let's say every house he is now issuing sand, cement, and then a jelly, and then afterwards angles, channels, beams, structurals, etc. So more than 200 categories of items he is doing it. So he wanted to have the charge account for each and every project, project wise, category wise, he want to have a charge account. So we have configured all the category wise charge account to him. And then they are all expense accounts only. They are not asset accounts. So they are all expense accounts. And then when we buy, there is a different one. And then what happens? Accounting is different one actually. Fine. Accounting is a different one. So they account for, let us say, cement. On a particular project, it will tell you how much of cement has been consumed, sand, how much is being consumed, etc. Very many categories. How much of money has gone into the project actually for all the categories. And then they, what happens, do the roll up of everything and then with the report only. and then they will analyze about how much of money is being spent for the particular this thing. Let us say your particular house is costing you 100,000 and then they have spent around 64,000. So 36,000 is the margin which they have earned actually. And then they will not try to optimize it. And then on the next project, they will not try to reduce the expenses or what happens for extra futures, how much is money is going to cost. So many analysis is being done on the MIS level, management information system level. So that is being used excessively. So charge account becomes a very important one as far as their project is concerned. Actually. Got it now, fine. So normally all these accounts will be an expense account. They'll be having a separate account and then that will be hitting it and then they will now analyze this on this. Now getting an idea? Manan? Or still not clear?
What about project? Projects also will
be coming into picture. Right? Projects also will be coming into picture. So we implemented a projects only for a Muscat company, a building construction company. So each and every house is a project for them.
No, I said about our project accounting.
That's what I mean. Project accounting will come into picture. I already have what's called. Okay, fine. It is not for you actually. So project accounting is a separate module. Fine, you have to talk to one of the financial guys who will be doing this project accounting. So let me go there and then see the fusions purchasing accounting. So let me share it. Fusions purchasing accounting will begin. So for which, what you're going to do is we are now going to create the accounts. Fine, we're going to get the accounts and then wait. Go to this place. And then I go there, click on it, and now go to the Fusion Procurement Documentation. Here we have Fusion Purchasing Accounting Document. So on your Fusion Procurement Documentation, we have one Fusion Purchasing Accounting. When double click on it, you'll now have it. So let us first of all create all these accounts. When 13 accounts are there, so let me create all these accounts for them. So we'll take away it. So we'll now go and then create it in our system. So go there, go to this place. Go there. So I will now go to the place, click on search now. So manage, fine, chart percentage, value percentage, set percentage. So I'm going to do it now. Value percentage, set percentage, manage chart of accounts, value set. So manage chart of accounts, value set is the one. Let me query my value set. Mine is everything is all starting on J05 and J05 the one. So go there. So click on search. We're going to search for it. So click on search, we'll be getting this account, J05. Why it's not coming? Startup accounts will be J05, no? What is the value you given there now? You go there, you go to the rapid implementation for procurement now. And we'll open up this and then have a look at it. So go to this place. I changed it actually into the J05 only. J05 is the chart of accounts. I don't change it for other guy actually. It is not CH1, it is the J05 actually. So the chart of accounts name is J05. But why it's not appearing here now? What is the mistake I'm making?
But is this the same instance, Nana? We did.
ADH. The one that I am.
It is a value set, sir. You can query with the accounting percentage J05.
Second, it is say US is not saying nothing. I will say US. So click on search now. User account is now coming as chart of accounts managers. Let us now go there and then go to the manage chart of accounts. Manage chart of accounts values is the one. Manage sets values. We'll go to the manage chart of accounts value sets values. I think I had to go to the value sets values. Now I go there. No, say J05. Value set values. I had to query. Value set code is J05. What is the number? J05 space US. No, fine. Space US. Now. So I was working on this number. J05 US, what happened?
Nana sir, try with the segment code percentage your user name. Company percentage J05.
In this place, huh? Code, huh?
Yeah.
What is the thing I had right now? Tell me.
Segment in company.
Company.
The segment in your rapid implementation, yeah.
One second. I will now go to this one. Manage chart of accounts structure system or you. So I will now go there and then first of all see manage chart of accounts structures now. We'll now see the segment name is the yeah, that's correct. So click on search now. I had to find out the segment name, find the manage structures. So here I have no structure. This is J05. This is structure now. Structure is J05. So if you go there and then click on edit, you will now see the segment name. Okay. It's a company department account only. So company department and account are the values. So they have not provided any what's called specific one on this. No fine. How to do this? No fine. Company department account. Everybody will be having the same thing. No. Right click, and then duplicate now. So it is a company one. Let me query on the company. Will now see the fine. Click on it. It's a company department account. It was set up and maintenance. Go there. So click on search now. So it's a manage percentage, char percentage, value percentage, set percentage. No. And company segment, I will now query. Manage account analysis. I will now query for the company, C-O-M-P-A-N-Y, and then entering now. So there will be multiple companies will be coming now. And I have to choose my company also. So many companies are coming. How come I can find out my company now? This is the company segment now.
It should be the first one only, I think. Because the name is
everybody has, okay. Somebody made a company is there. Oh, company.
Sir, if you want exactly check your COA instance, structure instance, you can check.
In this one, fine.
I'm now you checked only. Check your instance.
Okay, instance you are asking me to check.
Come out of this.
Okay. Instance name you are asking for it. I click on done now. Hey, it is Abina.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. J05 and enter now. She's giving good ideas now. I'm going to click on it. No query for this now. We'll see the values. It's also again company. So value set code is company, company J05 US. Okay, fine. So likewise, you can even see. Fine, I will not take a copy of it now. Man. Right click and then copy. No, it's not possible. Company J05 US. Go there. Company space J05 US. Query for it. Click on search now. Are you getting it or not? We got it. Company J05 US is coming. Good. Fantastic, Abhi. So we'll now go for the accounting segment. Accounting, account J05 US is the value set code. Account J05 US. Good. That is the way those who are come from Japan, they are always brilliant, actually. Account J05 US. Remember. So this way you have to query. Remember, you have to also query like this now. Fine. You go to this place. I will again say, you go there, go to the structure instance, and then find out the value set code for your value, actually. Got it? And everybody has to query like this now. So go there, and then query for the search now. So you'll be getting it. Got it. So you go there, and then click on, you already have an association to the flux field structure now. So select it, and then click on the manage value. Anybody has got a query? Anybody has got a doubt on this now? Fine. So you have to query like this now. Fine. So if it is a, my structure is what? My, this thing is, if you go there, it is a, CH1 is nothing but J05. J05 space US. So J05 space US is my one. Fine. So you have to query like this now. So your account space, your prefix space US. You have to query. Got it? So select it and then click on the manage values. I'm now going to add the values. So click on manage values. You click on search now. Fine. Plenty of thousands of values will be there now. Fine. I'm now added. So here it's all starting on what? 1110. But our values are not reaching the 1110 at all. If you go on and have a look at it, okay. Our values are leading what? If you go to the percentage only, 1000 to 1012 only. So it don't clash at all. Fine. That doesn't matter. So I will not keep on plusing. Now, fine. Click on plus. I will not keep the same values over here. Now. Click on plus. I'm not going to create the values. So plus I created. Fine. It is 1000. I will not put 1000. And then go there. The account type is asset actually. I will not make it as asset. Give a same at every point of time, you give a same. And click on plus one. No, that. So next is what? 1001 is a liability. I'll not add this. 1001 is a liability. 1000 is there. So I will not. Oh God, attribute value set. It is not saving at all. It is required. You must enter the value for the attribute type, account type. Account type is there, asset now. What else is not there? Yes, yes, no, no. Allow posting, allow budgeting. Third party account is no. Everything is there now. 1000. Why it is not saving now? I click on save. Attribute value in value set. Value setup. AM, Oracle apps, FND, Apple Core, flux you find is required. You must enter the value attribute account type. Come on, I didn't know.
Check DFF or something.
Any DFF is there? Oh, like you call it. Go to the further end now. Financial category is not required as it's for this now. It is only asset. Don't say, I'm not saying at all. I'm going to give it cancel again and then come back to this place now. Go to this place. Click on the manage values now.
Nana, can you query only that specified value instead of querying all the values?
Query.
Because I think there were so many rows were there. Maybe one of the rows.
1000. Account type is what? Set. And then give a save. It is not saving at all.
No, the value is getting cleared. Say.
Value is getting cleared. So shall I do 10,000 now? Fine. I'll not go for 10,000 now. I'll not say whether I have given any restrictions on the number of this thing or not. I'm not sure about it. I go for 10,000 now. The same. The value 10,000 is too long. Its value set account J05, the length of the value cannot exceed 4 characters. That is what it will not say. So I will not say, I will not go to 2,000. 2,000 also may be there now. Right? I will not put, so let's say 7,000. No, put 7,000 over here now. So many values are already there now. Right? Is it now clashing with the existing values or not? I'm not sure about it. 7,000. So click on save now. Attribute value in value set Oracle application model applicable. Value search is required. What does this mean here? Value search is required actually. It's not coming at all. So we'll do one thing. We will now change our sheet to the existing one. That is the best way now. Right? Whatever value is already created, we will now change it to our existing one. And that we will now populate those things. So it is not 1,000 is already saved. Oh, see, 1,000 is saved now. 1,000 is saved. So if you give a cancel, it is now giving you an error, but it has now saved it actually. You cancel now. If you go to this place, manage chart of accounts value sets, it is now saved actually. Go there. It is a company. Let's say it is the account actually. Account J05 US. Click on search now. Select and then click on manage values. 1,000 seems to be saved now, right? So click on search for the 1,000 value. Sorry. And then click on search now. It is there. Okay, fine, doesn't matter. Fine. Let us now go and then continue this now. So 1,001. I will now give a final save. Or afterwards, after 5 entries, I will now make a save. So it is a liability. 1,001 is a liability. So click on plus now. After 5 entries, I will now give a save and then wait. 1,002 is an expense now. 1,002 is an expense now. So click on plus now. I want to say 1,003 is owner's equity. 1,003. It's owner's equity. At this stage, I will now give a save now. Fine. 1,000 to 1,003, we are done now. Fine. Click on save now. Save and close. Come out of it now. Again, go to the manage values. No, this time it is not giving any error. No, fine. Click on search. No, fine. Come on. 1,000, 1,001, 1,002, 1,003. Vandichi. We got all the things. No. So click on plus. No. We'll now go ahead and then do it. No. So first time, go there. 1,003. 1,004 to 1,008 is expense. No. 1,004 to 1,008 is expense. So 1,004, and then make it as an expense. No. Expense. Click on plus. 1,005. Is an expense now. So 1,005 is an expense. Make it as an expense now. So click on plus. Go here. And then 1,006, 1,004, 1,006. I'm putting it as an expense now. Click on it. I'll make it as an expense. So click on plus. 1,006 is
these done. All are natural accounts?
Natural accounts only. Everything is natural accounts. 1,007, 1,008. You got only 3 segmental one. So this is a natural account segment actually. Expense. So click on plus. and I'll go there, and then we'll now make 1,800. So make it as an expense. Click on it and then save it up and click on save. Save and close, and then come on up here and then see this one. So click on manage values and then make a query. Click on search. Up to 1,008 we already made. 1,000 up to 1,008 is already there. Go to space. Now 9, 10, and 11 are asset actually. Click on plus.
Nana, 1008 is budget. You have changed account type.
Oh God. Oh, I did it. Go there. It's expense now. So it's now save now. Click on save now. Any other mistakes? Good mistake. Good observation. So I go there. So 1,009 to 1,011 is asset now. 1,009 is an asset. Ah, must have the value for that. Where is it? It's not showing you some error now. Here it is asset now.
Nana, maybe 1,009 is already created due to this there.
One second, let's see. Save. It is accepting it. Okay, so click on plus. Because I jumped this place to that place, now fine, that is why it's not showing error. When I was creating it, I jumped it. That's the reason. So 1010, go there. And then make it as an asset now. Ah, it shows you some error, but it is accepting it. When goes, I click on save and close now. You know, see. It is accepting it. When goes, the manage values. So 1,000, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, 1,005, 1,006, 1,007, 1,008, and then afterwards, 9 and 10 are assets actually. So 11th is again an asset now. Fine, click on plus. We'll now make the 11th as an asset now. Go to the top. So 1,011, 1,011, go there. We'll now make it as an asset now. And then afterwards, we had to have one liability account. 1,012, fine, click on plus now. We'll now have one liability account. So in the top, it will be there now. So 1,012 is a liability. 1,012. So our simulation is now perfect. Now fine, go there, click on save and close. Then we're simulating it. Then again, go to the manage values and then look at the total values which are given. Now fine, click on search now. So have a watch on it. Now fine, asset, liability, expense, owner's equity, then expenses up to 8. Now fine, 9 and 10. 9, 10, 11 are asset. Fine. 9 is asset, 10 is asset, 11 is asset, and then 12 is our liability. Fine, good. Fine, you will not give a cancel. When you came inside for only for viewing it, do not give a save and close, remember. When you are gone inside only for viewing it, so at the time, what happens, you will cancel and then come out. That is the software logic. Software logic says what? If you are not gone for any modification, give a cancel and then come out. Fine. Here you have to save and close now. Click on save and close. Here it is save and close. That's it. So we are now simulated everything. Now, let us now create one expense subunit also. Asset subunit is there, fine, go there, click on it. Let us now create an expense subunit. So we'll now go on and create an expense subunit. So it's a manage percentage, sub percentage, lookup percentage. So let us now create our expense subunit. So organization is what? J051 now. So for this, I'm going to do it. That is my child subunit, child R. So for the child org, I'm going to create $5. I will not click on plus now. I will not put expense subunit inside. Here we need to have an exact one because otherwise what happens in the manage mapping set, they don't have any list of values basically. That is why I had to put exactly the value now. Sub expense, paste it. So location is what? J05. And then give it app. So the location is coming now. So nothing is modified. Here, remove the asset subinventory. It becomes an expense subinventory now. Like what we did in EBIS now. Fine. So EBIS is also very removed. It.
No, but the quantity track is default enabled. How we can disable that?
It can be done only with the power location. The quantity track can be disabled only with the power location. Fine. If you want to go for it, then what happens? There are so many other setups are there. So that only will now make it as a what quantity track is an non-quantity track. So I don't know about how to do this now. Fine. That is totally not known to me. So once when I learn it, I will let you know. Fine. Whether the quantity track can be removed now. That's it. Fine, go there. So it is an expense subinventory. Fine, go there. Click on it. It is now.
Now quantity won't be tracked. Now quantity won't be tracked.
Quantity will be tracked. It is quantity tracked is enabled now. Quantity tracked is enabled now. How to remove it? I don't know. Fine. That is, I'm yet to learn it now. Fine. There are three techniques are there. periodic automatic replenishment and then replenishment counting and then Kanban replenishments. With that setups only we can remove it now. So I'm not aware of it. So I'm into learning
because can you subinvent the type or if type you change it to storage to expense?
Where is the storage here?
And sir, usually in EBIS.
Here receiving. Receiving is only for WMS, remember. It is not for this thing now. Receiving is a different one now. Receiving is for Logfire actually. Storage subinventory is the one only for Fusion actually.
In the during the starting the session or during the session, you have said if we don't want to track the quantity, then you can also disable. So I am correlating to that part.
No, you watch this in my EBIS videos, 25th record. I have done everything on this now. Fine. How to remove the quantity tracker log. Fine. Here I don't know how to do it now. Fine. Here I don't know. So when I learn the techniques of PAR, I will teach you. Fine. Because there is a technical installation of a REST and Postman services. Then only it can work now. And then the PAR, the RC and Kanban are fully explained on my 25th video. In 25th video, you download and then watch. You can see about how EBIS is done now. Fine. There's a Jujube one. It's a very easy one now. Here is a technical one. I don't know. So click on 7 close. Now this is an expense subinventory. So expense non-tracked, I don't know how to do it. If anybody knows it, please tell us. So click on save. So we are not done it now. Exactly copied and then pasted now. So we are now done the subinventory.
No, that's controlled at the item attribute level now.
No. There is a subinventory control. There is not item control.
No, whether an item is...
Item is an expense or not, we are going to create now. Fine. We are going to create an item now. Fine. We are now going to get two items now. Fine. Item control and subinventory control are totally different now. You can see asset item in this way. What happens? You can see asset item into an asset subinventory, asset item into an expense subinventory. Fine. Item controls are different from subinventory controls. Clear on this now. Subinventory is quantity tracked asset subinventory. Item has got inventory item and then inventory subinventory. So let me create two items and then do it. Fine. Let us now create the item now. Item controls has got nothing to do with this. So let us now go on and create it now. Fine, go there, click on it. We'll now create one asset item and then one expense item now. You go to the product management, go to the product information management, and then let us now create one asset item and then one expense item for the stretching. So click on create item. I will now be creating an item. So I will now put J05 and then 0 is the organization. Fine, go there, click on it. Everything will be coming. Fine, click on OK now. We'll now create an asset item. Like in EBIS, I did now. Here also, I'm now getting two add-ons. So go there. It's a J05_asset_item. So it's an asset item. Fine, go there. So take a copy of it and then put on this place. Now paste it over here now. And then I will now go and then directly associate the org. If you go to the specifications, I will now see the list price of this item now. Go to the purchasing now. I'm purchasing. And then the list price is already populated as 2 now. Fine, will be coming. It's okay. Fine. Go to the associations and then associate with the child org directly. Associations and then let me associate with the child org directly. Go to actions and then go to select NAT. So let me go on and add it. So it's a J051 entry.
So that quantity tracked is controlled by material status.
Oh. It is controlled by material status. Huh? Okay, good. So he's saying that using material status, we can very well make it as what? Non-quantity tracked. Fine. Go on. Who is this?
Dinesh.
Dinesh is saying, fine. You please experiment and then tell us, and then afterwards we'll launch it.
We need to enable netable, then only it will be editable, sir.
He's saying through material status you can make a change. That's a good.
Need to enable the netable.
No. Very good.
Then only it will be edit mode.
Editable. Okay. Netable can only be non-quantity track. That's what you're saying, na? Fine. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Good observation. Excellent, yeah, guys. So netable only can be non-tracked. That's what he's saying. Now, fine. That you want. Now go that click on it. I will now go to create item. Let me create the expense item also and then come over here. So it's a J050 is the one. Go there, click on OK now. I will now get the expense item over here. So it's a J05_expense_item. So take copy it and then put the description now. So I go to the specifications and I will now make it as an expense item. So go to the manufacturing. In this place, I'm in the manufacturing area. So inventory asset value, no means what? It is an expense item. Costing enabled is basically for the functional area. It must be on, no, and then this must be no. So yes and no combination makes it as an expense item actually. Yes and no, inventory asset value. So go to the associations and then let me associate to the child R. Click on association. Go to actions and then go to self NAT. So I'm going to associate to the child R. J05, and then enter now. let me associate with the child. So let me say, so we have now created both organizations, and then we'll now go there and then have a look at that one of a non-quantity tract. Click on it, go there. You go to setup and maintenance. So please teach us whenever you know something now. Find that one. So go to search now. Go there. Is a managed percentage, sub percentage. Look up percentage in the maintenance now. Go there. Go to the place. And the, we are already in the J051. Go there. Click on it. Expense ability. I will now edit it now. Click on edit. And go there. Edit it. And then if you put a depreciable on, then also is not coming here.
Material status is active. Can you change to the material status to some other non-netting material status?
Okay. That's what you're saying. Now.
Where change it to reject now, sir.
Instead of active, you can
change it to reject. It will be editable.
Rejects. Okay, fine. Now the quantity tract can be enabled. Okay, this topic I made to come to that now. Fine, we'll now see. If you change the material status, then what happens? It is now editable, not by depreciable basically. Okay, it is now associated to the material status now. Fine, whereas in EBIS, it is not so. We can directly go and remove it now. We can. There are so many things on the PAR and then RC, and then if I do it, whatever, they'll be dealing with it. So this is now done. So we have simulated the sub-inventories, we have simulated the accounts now. Now we are going to set up our managed mapping set now. So here again, there are multiple combinations now. So there also these combinations are available, but I have not demonstrated that now. Fine. This many combinations I have not demonstrated. Here I'm going to demonstrate all the combinations over here. Asset item into an asset sub-inventory. Fine, go there. So the material account, what happens, the sub-inventory level, we are doing now. Fine, there's a scope now. Fine. So I will not go there, click on it. I will not go to this one, done now. I will not come to the main one. I will not set up the first three and then check it up, and then after the next three, like that, what happens, they'll not go. So I am in this place, I go there, I will not go to the management, manufacturing and supply chain management, and then I go to the managed mapping set. Manage percentage, map percentage, set percentage. In one of our implementation, financials has totally changed everything now, fine. They have changed all the mapping sets to their tune actually. So you go there, go to the cost accounting. Fine. So manage mapping set of cost accounting, I'm going over there, I click on it. I'm going to go to the manage accounting also. I click on the manage mapping set, and then here I will now choose what? Material account sub inventory now. So go there, expand it. I will now put the material account sub inventory. Material, I will now query it now. Fine. So I'll now query it. So material account sub inventory, I'm going to choose now. I will not choose the material account sub inventory. So here I'm going to add it. Material account sub inventory. I'm going to add it. So click on plus now. I will now add my chart of accounts. Go there. So go there, drop it on J. I'm going to put J05. So it's now J05 is the one thing. I will now add the account now. J05 US must be coming over here now. Fine. Wherever your cursor is there, that has to show over here now. I will now put the account over here now. Fine. So this is the one. So 1009 is the account which has to put now. Fine. What is 1009 I have to put now? So I will now go there, click on it, drop it down. It is 01 is what? I don't know the company name and all. This one. I will now say 01. The department may be 000. The department can be 00. So here it is 1009 is the one which I'm going to give it. Click on it. Click on OK. So go there. So let me take a copy of it, and then afterwards you will now paste it. Take a copy of it. I will now use it for what? Secondary sub-inventory. Fine. It is for the inventory, sub-inventory. Fine. So we have to put the exact sub-inventory name over here now. Remember. So I will now take a copy of the sub-inventory name and take a copy of it. I will now put it. For this sub-inventory, when you do it on this sub-inventory, 1009 will be the account now. So it is a M01. No, okay. What is the thing here? I have changed it actually. This is an asset, na? Asset item to an asset sub-inventory. Okay, we have to take a copy of the asset actually. So here also I have to change it. I have not changed it. Fine, go there. So it's a yes, sub one is asset one. So I will not take a copy of this asset sub-inventory and go there and then put it on this place. Sub-inventory is what sub-inventory. It is not a default, remember. It is not a default. Fine, go there. So and then I will now put the organization also. Fine, is a J051 now. Got it now. Fine, go there. So I will now give a save. Point. So it is not a default. So for this sub-inventory of this or if you're transacting it, this will be a charge account now. Click on it. I will not give a save. We'll not see whether it's getting saved or not. Do it very cautiously. You have to paste it exactly. Even if you give one extra character, it will not work at all. You have to exactly do it. Extra character also. Hey, tell me, what is the doubt? Okay, what else? Please, all of you, mute your mics now. When you're not speaking, please mute your mics.
Nana, one question. Suppose we are having five different sub-inventories.
Yeah. Two sub-inventories, you can even have a different charge account. But if it's going to be common, you have to put a star or something like that, set as a default or something like that, and then do it now.
No, no, no. My question is that, Nana, for the fourth sub-inventories, we want some X account, and for the fifth sub-inventory, if the user is choosing that specific sub-inventory at the PO. So how we can we derive that account?
PO, there is no accounting at all, first of all, in PO, remember. Only Nana, when you receive the accounting is set, actually. PO do not have this account at all. We have only one charge account. Okay, fine, of course. This is going to default only in the PO. Okay, fine. Tell me, when he is going to put the sub-inventory, this account will default automatically on the PO. I will show you.
If it will, he will not enter any sub-inventory in that case.
Yeah, yeah. There will be one deep. We'll come to that. Wait. We'll not come to that. We'll come to that. So for this sub-inventory, 1009 is there now. We'll now make a check of it also. Right? You can save and close. I've forgotten all these things. Right? I'm now only watching this and moving on. So next entry is what? Asset item and expense sub-inventory. Right? What's that? I will now go to the same sub-inventory and then I will now enter for that sub-inventory also. Expense sub-inventory I'm going to enter now. So I go there, click on it. I will now add one more line for this number. So this is what is you select it. I'm going to add one more line. When click on plus now. I'm going to add it. So in this place, first of all, I will now paste this account and then oh god. So this only has to be pasted. Go there. I will now take a copy of that one. Take a copy of it now. I will now paste it over here. Can I cancel now? So I will now put it over here. Now. So here, organization is what? J051. There is no list of values. This is the biggest bug actually. 01000. Fine. 1010, I think. I'm going to call it. It's 1010, not 100. It's 1004 actually. So go there. It is 1004. If I make a mistake, please tell me now. So two sub-inventories have been entered now. For an asset, when you transact an asset item into an asset sub-inventory, 1009 will default. When you transact an asset item into an expense sub-inventory, 1004 has to default now. Go there. So click on save and close now. We'll again go there and then make a check now. I'm going to call it. Now go and move, go on and make a check. So go there, please. Choose this one now and consult and then go down. So 1009 and 1004. Asset is 1009, expense is 1004. Right? Give a cancel now. Now, this time I've gone only for looking at it. So I will not give a save or save and close. I will not give a cancel and then come out of it now. So these two entries are now made. We'll now go for the third one now. In case if you're not made any accounts at the sub-inventory level, then org will fire actually. Middle account org will move to fire. I will now set up the org level. So if you're not set up anything on the sub-inventory, then org will fire. This is a must. If this is not there, this is a must actually. We have already done it now. Fine, go that correct. We'll not change it now to our preference. Now fine, go that correct. We'll not go there. So choose this one now. Fine, go that. Why it is not coming? I've already given it. Huh? Oh God, it is not coming at all. I am in the material account organization. Now fine. So for doing it, I have already given an account. Now 1410 or something like that. I have given now. Fine. What happened to this? It's not visible at all. Give a cancel now. Click on yes now. And then give a done now. Count of it. And then click on the manage mapping set. And then query because I already given one account there. Why it is not coming? Go there. So I will now say EATRIAL, middle account organization. Middle account organization. Click on it. The logo there. Is that J05US is the one. You click on it, is there, right? 110. So this, let me change it now. I click on it. I'm going to change it to what? So if it is 1010, I'm going to make a change now. 1010. If you click on it, I will now make a change to 1010. 1010 is the one. So click on outside. Fine. That is for all the inventory orgs now. So if you want a specific inventory org also, we can give add a plus 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 and add it. So under the set as the default is there, we give a save. Let's see if it is getting saved or not. And then give a save and close. And then we'll again come back and then query now. Because we already given 1110 now. 1010 is the account we are given now. The new account we have changed now. Select 1010 is the account. So first three are now set. We are going to make a test of it now. We are going to make a test of it. So let us now make a test of it. We'll now make a test of it. I will now right click and then duplicate. Fine. We are going to test it on the requisition actually. Go there. So we'll now go there. I will now go to what? Procurement. I will now go to the procurement and then go to the purchase requisition. I'm going to make a check of it. So click on the purchase requisition. Let me make a check. So this one. So let me create a new requisition. Enter new requisition lines for the asset item. So asset item into an asset sub-inventory and then asset item into expense sub-inventory. So once when I put the asset item asset sub-inventory, 1009 will default. If it is an expense sub-inventory, 1004 will default. Fine, go there. So if these two are absent, I have to get 1010 now. That's what is. Go there. So let us now create an account. So org level file is a J05 asset item. I'm going to put it. I will not put the asset item over here. So here, by default, what happens if you go on and see that subinventory will be an asset subinventory only. So we are now default, by default, we are now given asset subinventory only. And go there. So you can now see the account has come as what? It will now come as what? 1009 is a charge account. Now for us. Go there. And then the default location is coming. Go there. 1010 is coming. It is not picking up your subinventory at all because subinventory is not specified. Right? So if subinventory is not specified, it picks up the org level one. Now. The org level value is what? 1001. So let us now put the asset subinventory where the charge account will become 1009. Go there. I will not drop down. I will not change the account. Subinventory now. Click on subinventory. So it is now picking up the org level. I will now put what asset subinventory. If you put it, it has to become what? 1009. You tap. So sometimes it doesn't change at all. So 1009 it has to become now. So what I will do is I will now simulate it. I will now add to cart. It will now automatically change now to 1009. If you add to cart. Otherwise, what you have to do is you have to go on the preferences. You have to make a change now. The subinventory also have to put it. Click on add to cart. So when you add to cart with these values, you're putting it, the account automatically gets changed based upon the subinventory. It is not 1010. I go that one. So go that one. So when you are creating a requisition without mentioning a subinventory, it takes only an org level. But when you are receiving it on the subinventory, the charge account automatically changes to 1009 while during receipt. Receipts will now override the PO's account actually. So we are now adding to the cart, and then if you go inside and then have a look at it. It will be what? 1009 now. So it is added now. I click on the hyperlink of this and then go on and have a look at the account. It will be 1009. Click on review now. So it is the org level. Go there. Click on it. It will be what? It will be coming. Fine. Go there. Click on it. It will be 1009. So the requester may not know the subinventory at all. So if he doesn't know, if you go there, you will now remove it. He may not know at which subinventory he wants to receive. If you give a save, if you give a save, it will now automatically become to 1010. If you don't put any subinventory, it will now go as what? 1010. If you put an expense subinventory, it will now become 1004. Click on it. So requester may or may not put. But at the time of receiving, if you're receiving it on the expense subinventory, the account which will be recorded will be 1004 only if it is absent here. Got it now? I click on save now. It will become 1004. So it will now become 1004. So we have tested the first three now. The first three is tested now. So asset into an asset subinventory, asset into an expense subinventory. If subinventory accounts are not provided by the requester, then it will now pick up the org level account now. Now tell me, Vinay, what is your doubt now? Is it the doubt? If the requester has not put any subinventory, it will now pick up the org level account now. Now, next is what? Expense account into an expense subinventory. Expense account, expense item into an asset subinventory actually. Expense item into an asset subinventory. You know, this is a very complex one. I will tell you the complexity later on. Fine, let me demonstrate it first of all, and then afterwards tell you the complexity. Fine, go that on it. I will now go to the manage chart of accounts. Fine, go that on it. Not this one. Manage mapping set. Fine, go that on it. I will now give a cancel. Fine, because this one, wherever you want, you give a cancel only. Remember, don't commit anything at all. So here, I will now have to check query for what? Expense account, not material account. So I have to query for the expense account now. Fine, go that on it. I will now query the expense account. You talk to Vignesh, do you know how difficult it is? Because they have pushed it to this place and then they are finding it very difficult actually.
Nana, one question. Nana, suppose we have 100 inventory of for the PO2 to be generated, and for each inventory of there are 30 to 47 inventories are there.
Yeah.
So in that case, we just want key for specific sub-inventories, the charge account need to be generated.
Okay.
So how we can create this rule? Because if we're going to enter 50, what the...
About 50 sub-inventories, out of which only 4 sub-inventories are having a charge account.
Default rest having
okay, there is a simulation, isn't it? Fine. Out of 50, only 4 you are given a subinventory level charge account. If subinventory yes. level charge account is missing, it will not pick up from the org. If it is not
in that case,
also
we...
it is not specified also, it will not pick up from org. But org needs one at least. Otherwise, accounting will fail. So, transaction will pass, but accounting will fail when you're in the costing area. And you are transacting like this now. Fine, brother. If you're transporting expense account into an asset subinventory. And then if you are not provided anything here, it will not pick up from the expense account org. And if you, this is also not specified, that costing will fail actually. Remember, it's very, very important. That is why I am asking you people not to touch this area at all. Fine, it is a very, very complex one. Fine, go there. So let me add it. So click on plus now. Let me add it. Go there. I will not choose mine now. J05. This is a really a very tough one, and then people will now bombard you if you make a small mistake also. So this is an expense, basically expense account. Expense account sub-inventory level. Fine, go there. So expense item into an asset sub. First three is asset into asset, asset into expense, asset into whatever asset or expense. Fine, go there. So all three are not. So expense item into an asset sub inventory, you're going to fund the expense account. I'm charging it. So here I have to put what the asset sub inventory. Take a copy of the asset sub inventory exactly. Take a copy, go there, and then here in this place, whatever I already there. Fine, click on plus now. Fine, go there. I will not put the exact asset sub inventory name. Fine, go there. You have to paste it. There is no list of values, remember. So J051 now. Fine, go there. So here, what is the account I'm giving it to give it now? Fine, go there. So 01000. What is 03, na? I'm not sure about it. What is the thing? Anybody remembering it? So here I'm going to put what 1004 again, the same account I'm putting in. So I'll now put what? Remembering it, the company number, it is 03, na? Okay, nobody is remembering it. Click on it.
01. 01,
okay. Company is 01.
Yes, 01.
01000. And then 1004 is the one. Click on it. What happened? Give a cancel now. It is 1004. So click on OK. The combination is not valid. How come?
The there is one character after zero.
Oh God.
Dot is a dot. Yeah.
Very good now. Fine, go there. So 1004 is not given. So this is what is called expense item into an asset sub inventory. Now expense item into an expense sub inventory is 1005. I'm going to put it up. So click on plus now. I will now add one more line. So I will now first of all paste the account over here now and then make a change to it. Go there. Then I will not take a copy of this expense account. Please mute your mic. They are not picking up. I will now say capital J 051. There is no what am I list of values. You have to write it exactly. So two sub-inventories have been given now. Fine. Click on save now. And then save and close, and then come back and then again make a check. So expense account sub inventory, I'm going to make a check. So keep your cursor on this place now. And then here, what happens? You can now see both the items, the other accounts are coming. So it's all okay. Give a cancel and then come out of it. And then we'll now go to the expense account organization. So there we are going to give what 1006 actually. 1006. So we'll now go there. So click on plus now. I'm not going to go it. Drop it down and then go there. J05. We use now. Click on it. Go down. And then here I will now give a plus now. Click on plus. And then here I will now say what about the org level now. Fine, account I will now put output. I'm going to put it up. Fine, with it. Oh, okay. Check. 01-000-1006 is the one. Fine, go there. Inventory org is J051 now. So at the org level, I'm giving it as 1006. Fine, give a save and close. You will now go and then check it directly. Fine, give a what happens. You go by that. So what happens, you know, can I add item now? Yeah, actions, and then add is not there at all. Why there? Why are unable to add a line here? Acquisition lines, we are unable to add shop. So let us now go there and then go to the more task and then go to the update requisition preferences. And then here, I will now put the sub inventory as what asset now. By default, I'm putting a sub inventory as asset. So when you buy, you're going to buy for what? For a particular sub-inventory. That means what? A sub-inventory is an organization you're going to buy. So we have 10 organizations. If you're buying for the sixth one, first of all, you have to come over here and then set up your sub-inventory. Then only should go. If you're submitting the sixth sub-inventory, sixth org sub-inventory, then you're buying it for sixth org, remember. Fine. So requisition preferences has to be edited every time whenever you're changing the org. Please take a note of it now. Fine. When you're running the video again, fine. Let us say we are having 10 orgs and then you want to make a purchase for the sixth org. So open the preferences and then the sixth orgs, one of the sub-inventory you have to paste over, you know. Remember? Afterwards only you should go and then get a requisition. That is the way you have to do it. Remember? So first preferences must be set for the particular org. Then you go there and then do it. Then you are buying it for that org, remember? And then when you make a change there, and then afterwards if you want to make a change here, it is not possible. There are some restrictions where there are no. In the outside, let us say it is a location 6 and then you made it. You want to make it as location 9. Sometimes it doesn't allow at all. preferences dominate. Make a sure, I'm not sure about the present condition. I'm telling about the 4 years back condition. So when whatever, whichever org you want to buy, first of all, set the preferences and then commit. Sometimes you will not be able to modify at all. Find the logs. I will not put the expense item over here, J05. So expense into an asset sub-inventory. That's the first scenario we are going to do it now. Find that. Expense item into an asset sub-inventory. So I will not put the expense item over here. And then sub-inventory is asset. Now fine. Go there. I will not have 005 coming up as an org now. Go there. Go there. So 004 is coming. So here itself, we will not change it. Fine. Without going into design, fine. Go there. I will not change it to what expense sub-inventory. If you change it to expense sub-inventory, it will be 005 now. You can see. It is not becoming. So in that case, what happens? You have to only add to cart and then is there any possibility to re-trigger it actually here in this place? Re-triggering is possible. Oh, nowhere is there. Fine. Let me add to cart now. So let me add to cart. Already one item is there now. Fine. Now two items. So only through cart only we can add. We are unable to add it via that way. You know, basically. So go there. So it's an expense item. If you go on and see, an expense item into an what? Into an expense sub inventory. Then what happens? It will be 1005. So if you remove it and then save it now, fine. Go there, save it. Then it will become 1006 actually. If the requester is not sure about the sub inventory and then if he's saving it, what happens? It will not become expense sub inventory. 1006 it has become. Got it now, fine. Now we'll now go for the next one now. So the first six cases are tested actually. Now employee's expense account will become the what happens the charge account. So let us say I am an employee. I want the purchase officer to make an AMC contract on a particular supplier. So it will be accounted against my account actually. So I'm now going to set up the expense account of an employee to 1007. So go there. I will now set it up. Right click and then duplicate now. I'm going to set up the expense account of the employee actually. So go to the what's called my client groups and then go to the person management and then I'm going to set up this employee. Now I'm now putting the same employee as a requester, purchase officer, everything. In reality, remember, this is a requester's charge account. No, remember, requester's expense account will now become the charge account. So go to the EMP1, J05. In reality, we have to query the person who is creating this requisition. His expense account will now become the charge account for this. So click on it now. Go there. I'm now querying it. So click on query now. The real complexity will now begin tomorrow only. Go there. So I'll now click on it. I'm now going to edit it. And then I'm going to put the expense account as what? 1007. I'm going to put it. Now.
Sir, one question.
Tell me.
Preparer, there is no any setup, specific setup for preparer.
That is still not very clear on this. No, fine. If you know, if you ask in eBiz, I will not tell you. Fine.
Okay.
I don't know that preparer and requester. eBiz excellently works now. Fine. So go ahead. I will not click on it right now. eBiz also, whatever. I need a structure actually demonstrate. Actually, if I have a structure, I would have demonstrated, but I don't have a structure actually. It beautifully works. The preparer and requester, we can very well change actually. I will tell you the concept actually. Afterwards, I will not tell you the answer. What exactly is preparer and requester? That excellently works actually. We have done it many times actually in our actual work. Here, fusion, so many things are not clear. And Maha is already saying when you run the concurrent, it is not working at all. We'll also run the concurrent and then see, you know. So I'm now in the edit mode, I go there. I'm now going to put the expense account of the employee. So employee's expense account, I have to populate. Where is that expense account here? Direct reports. Manager details is there now. There will be an employee's expense report. Give an update now. Come on, it's not coming at all. Set employee nominee details is coming. Probation periods, direct reports, retirement, collective agreement. It is still not coming. Employee's expense account will be coming in the bottom actually. Person name is it. Oh God, you see, this itself is not clear at all. Why the assignment has gone now? I don't know. Maybe because of which is now giving a problem or not. I don't know. Sure. So click on type now. Oh God, there's no.
You clicked on add assignment instead of assignment.
Change. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Change assignment I have to do. Oh, that is having a functionality.
Yes.
Oh, God, I given add assignment. So that has got a functionality. That's what she's saying now. Fine, go that got update. So I click on add assignment. So that's not coming. So give a change assignment now. Fine. I will now go there and then assignment change. I will now do it. Add assignment is now giving a different one. I thought that it is not having any functionality. Okay, fine. Click on OK. Now, fine. Assignment change, I'm going to do it now. Fine. Abhi is given excellent one now. Fine. Abhi's suggestion are really excellent. So assignment change, what happens is she identified the problem on the values which you have to give on our chart of account value sets. So assignment change, I was thinking that this is not having any functionality. Assignment change, I'm going to give it set employee known as expense information, got it. This was not coming there at all. Good Abhi. So 1007, I'm going to give it. So the default expense account 01000.1007 is the one. So I have updated the default expense account for the employee. So whenever he makes any expense purchases, basically amount-based purchases are expense purchases, not quantity-based. Amount-based are expenses. So this account, he is responsible for it. Every employee will be responsible. So this employee is now creating how many requisitions, they can very well monitor now. So click on save now. And remember,
one small clarification.
Tell me.
Nana, you know, in the many companies, we have seen that there are temp workers, right?
Okay.
Those people who generally comes at 10 o'clock, putting their requisitions all the day, and they do not bother what happens in that case, right?
Yeah.
So here we are reflecting on the accounts for their name.
Yeah.
So how we are going to handle it? Because those people do not bother, right?
Yeah, they do not bother. But management will be bothered, na?
Correct. But unke naam pe jayega na wo sab kuch. How we are going
to handle it? Now, 1007, they can even take a report on a weekly basis or a monthly basis.
Okay.
Whatever purchases are made against the account of 1007, they can take a report now. So once when they take a report, later on they will now discuss with the employee why you are creating this money.
Okay.
It's for the later analysis actually.
Okay.
So the charge account, the purpose of charge account is to only analyze your spend actually. It is a spend analysis tool. Remember. Oh God. It is not saving at all. So after save, you have to give a review and then finally submit. So employee's expense account, we are going to give it. So once when this is done, we will now give a review. Review will now give you the change. Now fine. So add assignment, don't give. Change assignment is the one. I thought that it was not having any functionality, but now I understood through Abhi that that may be the mistake. We corrected the mistake actually.
Change. Nana, if HR model is not implemented, where to
depend? Yeah, it's working. It will definitely work. I have implemented one project for Kuwaiti company where HR is not implemented. All these things worked actually. You don't worry. Everything will work now. So click on review now. Click on review. So while reviewing it, what happens? It will show you what are the differences, what are the changes you have made now, and then finally submit. Only upon review, the submit button will be coming. Upon review, the submit button will be coming. So afterwards only you can do it. There is no need for HR module for all this purchasing accounting. Purchasing accounting is independent of HR. HR is mainly going to do what? You're going to promote an employee, you're going to sanction they leave, and then give an increment, and then all other activities of HR. Actually. Go down, and then see this now. So we have a default expense account change actually. The change is now coming from there. So click on submit.
Actually, Nana sir, this is Sheila. And then even though HR is not implemented, we implement partial HR for the procurement to be functional, right?
Okay. That is what you can create the jobs, you can give the positions, you can give the accounts, find line managers, you can decide, find all these things can be done even without HR license. Actually. If you don't have HR license also, you can very well do it.
Yeah, we call it for partial HR implementation.
You see, there are certain features which are built into your license actually. Whenever you buy and only purchase my brother. Now, I will now create what a service item, which is going to be description based. I'm not going to buy a service item. So service item I'm going to buy. I'll go there, go to the shop now. I will now give a cancel and go to the shop area. I'm clicking on shop area. So here I will now go there, go to the mode ask, and then click on the enter requisition lines now. I click on enter requisitions. And then here, what I'm going to do is I will not buy anything on the item at all. So any description based is basically service item. You have to change the line type actually. Fixed prices and services. This is basically quantity based bank that you want. So I'm not choosing a quantity based one. Bank that I'll now say AMC contract. AMC contract is the one. I will now put a category over here. Fine. I have a J05 desktop is there. Fine. Go that you want. I will now put a J05 desktop available. So once when I put it, the employee's expense account 1007 will become the charge account on this one. So it's not amount is 100. Go that you want. Amount is 100. You can now see. Go there. And then it's not coming here, fine, not coming. Give a tab, no. Does it come on often or not coming? Maybe if you add it, it'll not come now. Is there any other mistake? You know, fixed price and services. This one is there. Category is there. Delivered location also. I'm saying maybe if you remove the delivered location, is a mandatory field. You have to have it now. So we are given the fixed price services AMC contract. The category is now given. The account is not coming. So the account is basically editable, but it has to populate over here now. It has to come over here now. I don't know, it's not coming. So there is no save icon. No,
fine. No, add to do with the preferences.
Preferences. Okay. No, there we are now okay. We will not see whether that is there or not. Kind of that's one. Maybe we have to come via preferences. That's what he's saying. Who is this? We have to update the preferences first of all for expense actually. So we have to make a change to expense now and then afterwards go inside now. And if you have a project details also has been put on. So first make a change to expense now. Click on save and close now and then go for the requisition. Yes, correct, very correct. So go to the place and then go to the enter requisition lines. And then here, I will not change it to what fixed prices services. And then give a description of whether it is an AMC contract. Category name is J05. Desktop. Amount is $100. Go there. And then here, you see, it's not going. Is it, who is this? Who has given a suggestion now?
Karthik.
Karthik is now very correct. Fine. Japan Karthik is very correct now. So I was again and again repeatedly telling you that what happens, you have to first of all change the preferences for whichever you want to buy now. Whether it is for the 6th org or 8th org or 9th org or even for expense also, first change. First you change this. Then only go inside. So we got 1007. Now what happens is that we wanted to have a user preference for the service items. If I go that 1002, I'm going to give it now. So I'm going to give 1002. So you go there, click on it. I will now go to the update requisition preferences. No, I go that on it. So in this place, what happens? I will now add a favorite account. Fine, click on plus. No, fine. I'm going to add a favorite account. So I will now say Nana's expense account. Please in the field also give a name now clearly. Fine. Otherwise, what happens? The analyzing team will be finding it difficult about how this account has come. I go that. So it's a 01000. Fine. Go that. I will now put what 1002. I'm going to put it now. Fine. 1002. We'll now see. But how it's coming now. So click on save now. So this nickname will now enable the purchasing account analysis. Fine. Expense analysis will now give you a clear idea about what exactly is now. Fine. Give a save and close. Now nickname. Favorite charge account has been given now. So with the appropriate nickname, fine, so that they can understand about what exactly it is now in the field. Charge account is a very important one. And then you talk to Surya as well as you talk to Vignesh and all, fine, whether how much struggle they are having it now. Just, if you have so many categories, let's say 200 categories if you have, fine, I will know category-based charge account is tomorrow's topic actually. But again, we are not gone into the depth of it now, fine. We are not going to dive into the depth of it now. You just see. Andre will understand it. Okay, that's why accounting is very complex. But then if it is being pushed on your head, you are a bad, your luck is bad actually. I will not say. People will simply push onto the supply chain team. And then when the financial reporting, when they're taking the balance sheet, at the time, if the thing are not coming properly, at the time they will not shout on you. And you have to go dig, and then go to the depth of it. Tomorrow you're going to see transaction accounting built on the tab and tag. Oh God, it's such a difficult topic.
So, Raj sir, what is the significance of having multiple favorites accounts?
I don't know. It's a good question now. What are the significance of multiple? Any plus is available? One more plus is also available. No, fine.
Can I set different charge account for each individual organization?
Different charge account? What do you mean by? Yeah. That's one second. Let me first of all save and close. Let us first of all complete this now. I don't know, it's not giving you a reference, it's not saved now. If you go to the place, go to the enter requisition lines, it is an expense account, and go there. I will now make it as what fixed prices services are. Amount based one. Go there. Category is J05. Then give it up. So 1002 has to come now. So if you're given a favorite charge account, that supersedes the employee's charge account now. That will now supersede the employee's charge account. If that is not there, employee's charge account will be away. So when to supersede, that is the field decision. When to supersede the employees, the requesters charge account, when you want to supersede, that is the field decision actually. Got it now, fine. So this is the one. Now, the next one is what? Category-based expense account. I will not have a category-based expense account. So I will again go there. I will now have a look at it. Go to the manage chart of accounts, value sets. I will keep a customer account site and go there. How to see it? Okay, okay. Not this one. You go to this one. I know. Closed it totally. I will now say category-based expense account. So what Vinay Narula is saying that it is working here now. Fine. Let us now check it now. He's saying it's working. Previously, it was not working. And then we made a roundabout way. I'll tell you about how people have done it now. It's a very, very tough one. Manage percentage, I will not say. First of all, items expense account will not see. Items expense account, we have to set it. So in EBIS, what we do is, in the item itself, we can set it up. In this place, what you do is, you go there. You will now go to the items, and then go to organization items. And go to the organization. And then here itself, we are going to set it up. You can't just. Oh, God. No, lock-in session has expired, actually. Oh, no. Mozilla Firefox. Where is that?
Yeah. Down one, login.
Login. Okay. So, we have to get the login. So, I now go to the area and take up the copy of the password. So, here, in the item itself, we have the expense account. That is the biggest advantage. Go to the home now. Click on home icon, and say that goes along. So click on SNOP and order. Already logged in. So I will now populate the item file J05 and then give a tab. So click on OK. This was not working some 4 years back. Now Vinay Narula is saying that it is working now. So in this place itself, oh God, what happened? Now close it. Now again go there. Expense item is there. So if you go to the purchasing, we have an expense item over here, expense account over here. So this is the expense account. So I will now set up an account through manage mapping set now. And that will become the charge account we are giving it now. So that was not working. We'll now see whether it works or not. We'll now go to this place. So I have to go to what manage mapping set. So go there. I will now go to the what's called. You go to the manufacturing and supply chain management. And then here you go there. And then here, I will say manage mapping set, manage percentage, map percentage, set percentage is an entry now. So manage mapping set is the one. So go to the cost accounting. So not, sorry, I'm not, I made a mistake. It's not a cost accounting, it is a purchasing accounting you had to go now. So we had to go to the purchasing accounting on this one. How to trigger it again? Yeah, I don't go there, something else. It's a purchasing accounting I had to go now. I will again trigger it. So go there. I will now say manage percentage, map percentage, set percentage is an entry now. I had to choose the purchasing accounting. So for purchasing accounting, this is not the area. Fine. This is only for cost accounting and receipt accounting, and this is not the area. I had to go to the procurement. I had to go to the procurement and then search for this now. Fine, go to the manage mapping set, manage percentage, map percentage, set percentage. On the procurement, we have the items expense account now. Procurement transaction account, fine, the first one. And click on the manage mapping set of the procurement transaction account. So let us now go to the manage mapping set, and then we will now query the items expense account we are going to give it now. So you can say purchase expense account item is there now. This is a seeded by Oracle, actually. It is created by Oracle. Purchasing expense account item, we will now go on and say this now. Click on purchasing expense account. I will now add the chart of accounts. Click on plus now. Let me add the chart of accounts and drop it down. I will now say G. He's saying it is working, actually. If it is working, it is excellent, actually. So here I will now give a plus now. I will now put some account over there. So item number, you see, here they have given a what's called a list of value. It is not though in many, many places. No, fine. Here it is excellent, actually. J05. I will now put the expense item over here.
Nana, actually these values are coming based on the values that you are choosing at the input source.
That is why Yeah. That is why my financial team will always create their own mapping set, actually. They don't rely on the seeded ones at all. They create their own mapping set and then they do it now. Right? Excellent. I will know tomorrow. I'm going to see you about how to create your own mapping set. I'm going to teach you tomorrow. Now, right? So inventory org is J05 1. And go there. I will now put some account so that we'll see whether it works or not. Previously, it was not working. Probably there was a bug, I think, 4 years back. They might have fixed the bug, actually. I was telling about in the production instances that we had the problem. So I will now put some expense account over here. Something on the 5,000 or all expense account. If I click on search now. So click on search, blank search. Anything is in 5,000 area, whatever, it will all be expense now. So go there. Go down. 1000. It's still 1000 only. 50 will not search for it. 50. And then click on search now. So something. 5020. I'm going to choose it now. So click on OK. So 0100, 5020, if you put this item on a purchase requisition, it has to come. That means what? Item's expense account is working actually. So it is not done now. So click on save and then save and close now. It is not done. We'll now go there and then straight away shop. Click on done, come out of it, we'll now shop directly. Go to the more task and then go to the enter requisition lines and go there. I will now change it to what? I'm already in the expense only, no, I have to change it now. Right? I have to change it to inventory now. So go there, click on the update requisition preferences. I had to change it to inventory. So this is only for what your inventory is quantity based, expenses is amount based basically. I had to make a change to inventory now. Subinventory you can give or you not give. Now items account has to supersede everything now. So either way,
this item need to be done only for the catalog based requisitions or for the entry?
No, it is for the expense item. I'm telling you, expense. The catalog is going to come up now. Fine, next topic is catalog. So if you go to this place, So I am now putting an expense item over here now. So expense item into an asset subinventory, and then expense item into expense subinventory. And then if you don't specify any subinventory, then it should not pick up from R, but that 5020 has to pick up now. Got it now?
Sir, in the fourth row, value type should be asset, right?
Expense is asset actually. This account number, I don't know. Yeah, I only simulated it. You talk to financials. Expense to asset, what type of value you had to give?
No, value type I'm saying. You put as expense, it should be asset, right?
This is expense account only.
The fourth column, sir.
1, 2, 3, 4. What are the thing you are doing?
No, not fourth
column. Value type is expense only.
It's expense.
Okay. It's expense only. Asset, expense. Fine, expense. Is it expense only? The fourth column, okay. So now what happens? Now, since I have not populated any sub inventories, in this case, what happens if you go on and see this now? Right? You know, go on and have a look at it now. Right? Asset expense item. If I am not populating any sub inventory on an expense item into an asset sub inventory, expense item into an asset sub inventory, if we don't populate it, this account becomes a charge account. If you put a sub inventory, then the sub inventory's expense account will become a charge account. That subinventory is expense. Now, it's an expense item. You go there, you put out, you know, fine. I am not populating in subinventory. So, items expense account will now become a charge account. Fine, then what it is. I am not populating any subinventory. Fine, go that account. I will now go there and then do it. So, I know subinventory. Fine, click on save and close. But this also will not do it because otherwise that will be coming. And the charge account will now supersede. That one will now supersede. Now, fine, go that account. I will now delete it. So, this will now supersede everything. Now, fine. That will be problem. Fine. I'm not sure about it. You make a check of it. So that will be only for expense actually. If I go that tomorrow, I will not make a check. No subinventory has been populated. I will not populate an expense item. J01, J05. I will not populate an expense item. No subinventories at all. Expense item is not populated. No subinventory here. Go there. So no subinventory. Oh God, how come the delivery location has come over here now? Fine, like this. What is the account? 5020 is coming. Delivered location, how it came now? Because I have not put any subinventories blank. Na?
In preferences,
I have not done. See, first of all, items expense account is now coming automatically since I have not given any subinventory at all. The moment I put the subinventory over here, now fine, go that account. The subinventory's account will be coming. So I will not put an asset now. Fine. Asset means what? It will not change it to what? The subinventory's account. So the asset means what? 1004 has to come out. Expense into asset. What happens? 1004 has to come out. So go there. So I don't put the asset. I will now add to cart now. Add to cart and then see this one. J01 expense item one quantity. I will not delete others. No, fine. The one quantity, no? Expense item. Fine. So let me remove this two.
Sir, can you show us the preferences once, please?
One second. Let us go there. Let us now see whether it changes to 1004 or not. Fine. Because we have not put an asset subinventory over here now. So we have not put asset subinventory. So let us now go there and see whether it changes or not. It all works perfectly now. Tomorrow you will understand the ultimate complexity. It's very, very complex actually. When you go into add and tab.
Another question related to expense inventory. If you are using any move and request transfer and from asset to expense, it will work as a move movement request issue. It will work as a
Yeah. Movement request issue also will be having the same concept only.
So no. I am saying if we are doing movement request transfer from two sub-inventory, from is the asset inventory and two is expense sub-inventory.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
It will behave like a, you can say, movement request issue.
The inventory part, I'm not at all clear. I don't know. I'm not telling only about the purchasing part. In the purchasing, for when you buy an expense item into an asset sub-inventory, this is now firing. Expense item and an asset sub-inventory, this 1004 is firing. If both the things are absent, items expense account is coming excellent. Got it now, fine? When you move between asset to expense, I don't know what are the accounting entries actually. Fine? I have to learn the inventory part. I want to learn the inventory part. Nobody is teaching me. I'm only concentrating only on the purchasing part now. Inventory is not known to me. And go there, make a change. If you change it to expense, what happens? It will not become 1005 now. Go there, click on it. So you may change and then give a save now. Give a save.
Sir, actually, one question.
One second. Let us finish off. 1005. And if you remove it and save, it will be 5020. Let us save it. It will be 5020. Got it now? Fine. Okay, then now ask your question now. Fine, tell me.
Whatever the account we are setting at item level, that is the actual item account.
Item expense account, remember?
Yeah, item expense account.
You're now sitting, what expense item account, where is it here? Expense account item at the purchasing accounting cost management actually.
Yes, purchasing tab item expense account. So we set it at item level, but if no sub-inventory in the charge account, that item expense account is defaulting, which is okay. And when you receive into sub-inventory, then the account is getting changed.
It will refire again. Fine.
Yeah, account is getting changed, which is wrong, sir.
No. There is a reasoning for it also. Right? If you put an expense item, then what happens? Sometimes you may not even receive it. Let us say, I am now going to buy an expense item called Jailer Dance, which you may not even receive at all. In the case, what happens? The purchase orders account will be the ultimate account for payables actually. Mm-hmm. Only when you receive, it will supersede. If you don't receive, it will be intact actually. Got it?
Yeah, when we don't receive, then it is correct. Fine.
That's what.
But when we receive, it is, receive, it is getting changed.
Then it will be changing now. Fine. Based upon whatever you're doing now. Fine. Even there is an expense item. And then if you're receiving it in asset sub-inventory, 1004 will be automatically changed. And then if you do it in expense, it will be changing. And if you don't receive it, the 5020 is retained everywhere. Got it?
Sir, you mean first preference will be the item level account, next precedence is sub-inventory, and next one is organization.
Exactly. That's correct. First is item sub-inventory. If there is nothing there, item will be coming. If you put any of the sub-inventories, then sub-inventories account will be coming. If you don't put any of the sub-inventories, then if you put the org level is coming. If you say org level, if you put the org level, I don't know how to do it for expense item to org level. The shop level, how to make it to the org level? Yeah, fine. This is not possible. No, fine. That is not possible. So if you have an expense account there, and then if nothing is specified, only items 5020 is only populating. I don't know how to do it at the org level. And if this is absent, if the expense account is absent, then it will not populate the org level. 1006, it will not populate. Again, I'm not saying you have to do a lot of study on this now. Fine. So many permutations, combinations you have to study before setting it up. Actually, it is only an example I have given now. I will tell you, give you a document, you will know. Chakkar aa jayega tumko. It's really very, very tough. And so many combinations are there in this now. Many, many combinations are there. You have to, only for example sake, I have given the combination. Fine. Let me.
Sir, also. This is same as EBS currently, whatever we went
on. Same as EBS only. EBS, but everything is set actually. Yeah.
Yeah, but since years, because in my previous projects also we did the same thing. Mm-hmm. So we need to do charge account customization, because one segment from one place.
Customization means what? SLA.
Yeah, SLA. So here we don't have any standard solution for that.
Yeah.
One segment from one place, another segment from another place. It is not possible.
That's all very much possible. Yeah, there are so many infinite possibilities are there. Okay, since you have 1 minute, one more topic, I will now complete with that. What happens, I will now close the today's session. And then before I close the session, I will now show you the complexities which is involved on this. No, fine, go there. So one more thing. Fine, go there. So now, category-based charge account, you're going to see now. Fine, category-based charge account. That is what you're going to see.
Nana, before you start, could you please let me know this update preference? Is it at user level, instance level, or
user level? It is at a user level now. Every user has to update before he shop now. This we are now seeing very clear enough. And every user has to update before he shop now. he has to go there. First activity is what? He go there and then update his requisition. He is buying for which org? He is buying an expense item or an expense or asset. So he has to first of all update it. This patient you have to update.
Nana, here one small clarification.
Tell me.
Let's say item we have given the account on the subinventory, we have given the account or on we have given the account. And in the preference, we have put the favorite account. So favorite account will be super separate.
It's a good question, Nopin. Let us say, we will not see this, Nopin. But that is applicable only for expense, actually. This is, the favorite account is applicable only for the expense items and not for the asset transactions. Only when it is expense, then only the favorite will come. Nopin. So the inventory will not see what happens, Nopin. I don't think it will happen. So I will not say, for the asset item, this will not fire at all. It is only for the expense, actually. I will not say expense account. So I will now put what 01000 fine 1002 is the one. So it is inventory. Now this account will not fire at all. Fine. So go that I will now populate in this subinventory fine for that account. So in case when the subinventory is absent means what has to fire now? So asset into subinventories are absent means what 1010 has to fire now and not 1002. You'll now see. So I will now make a requisition fine for the entry requisition lines. Either inventory, I will now populate the item fine J05. I will now put an asset item. So 1010 will come. And not your 1002. No, the charge account will not come at all. So that is only for expense. No, expense purchases only. That preferences will be overriding the employees account. No, you go there.
Got it. Got it. Thank you.
I go there. So this will not override only when you are going make it as an expense. No. In expense, first of all, it will not go on and say the employees charge account. If this is there, this will not supersede the employees charge account. Actually. Got it.
Got it. Thank you.
So preference close. No. Now, category-based charge account, fine. Since our Vinay Narula has told that item-based charge account is working, now category also will work, I think.
Sir, no. Till now we saw item-based expense account, right?
Yeah, only for the expense items, expense account. No.
Okay.
Fine. We are now seeing what? Expense items, expense account. If you go there, so here, see, if it is an expense item, and then there is no sub-inventory space, where items, expense account becomes the charge account now, that we have seen now. That was not working from 4 years back. It is not working. So now category based charge account, I'm going to give it now. Go there, click on it. You'll now see the category based account. Go to the place. You're not going to go to this domain. So click on done now. Come on over. So here I will know how to go to the cost management only. Fine, go there. So we have what you know query.
Nana, one question. Tomorrow are we learning the how to replace each segment?
I don't know. When you'll see where that was not working now for me. So now it's working. We have to only jointly learn now. Fine, go there. We are going to be, we may learn tomorrow. We'll not see. So here, I have to come out of segment wise changing. We'll not try to learn. So I will now go to the place. I'll now make it the purchasing. Now. I go to the procurement now. So go to the procurement. And then here, I will now go to the manage mapping set. Entry now. Now, category based charge account, I'm going to go. Find manage mapping set of the procurement transaction account now. So click on the manage procurement transaction account. I'm not going to give that one. Go to the manage mapping set now. Place and then here you'll now say what happens. You'll be having purchasing natural account for transaction accounting builder is there. Fine, this is what a category level one. Now. Fine, one of them will be category level actually. So you'll now see this is a different one. So this is not saying skill category level one. It was not working previously. This also was not working. Fine, expense account item was also not working. Now it's working. I hope that this will also work. So purchasing natural account by purchasing category will not check whether it is working or not. Category wise purchasing account. Fine, with that and then all these things are only for expense, remember, not for asset. Asset has got only the standard combination. Fine, turn all of accounts, go there. Then drop it down. I will now go there. J05, I'm going to put it. J05 is the one. J05. I will now say category wise charge account. So click on plus now. If it comes as a list of values, it will be great actually. See, this is the biggest problem. Is requisitioning BU, procurement category is now coming. Requisitioning B also, I have to put it exactly. I know that procurement category also, I have to put it exactly. So, you know, go there. So, you know, see, look at the whatever they go there. Go to the place, right click on the duplicate. We have to put it populate everything very properly, otherwise, it will not come properly at all. So, go there. So, I will now go to the product management and then go to the product information management. I will now pick up the category properly. So, go to the browse items and then query my item and then see the category exactly. So the category has to be very proper, because there is not list of values is not there. That is the biggest thing which is missing on this. Since all the items are having only one category, that will be coming automatically. If I click on the other item, and the master org itself, because I'm not going to only look at the category actually. I'll go there. I go to the categories and then take a copy of the category. So here, what happens is J05 desktop is the one. I will not take a copy of it. Put it on this place now. Paste it over here. Requisitioning view also must be very proper. I will not go there. Right click and then duplicate. So I will now say manage business unit. I will go to the task, manage business unit, and then pick up the value. So these guys have not provided the list of values. Fine, these are all biggest ones. That is why financial team will disregard all these things now. Fine, they create their own list of values one, and then they will not do it. Manage business unit. See how difficult it is now. Fine, it's not an easy task if you make a mistake actually. Manage business unit is the one. I click on it. They go there. Go there. I will say J05. Enter it now. So in the business unit. Fine. This is the name of the business unit now. J05 space US. Fine. Go there. Take a copy of it now and then go to this place and then paste it exactly. Now I will now populate one account now. Fine. One account now. Oh, this is only what happens. Only the account is only going to be done because the segmental account. Actually, this is a segmental account. Account is only coming from that account. I will now populate some account and something on the file. I click on search now. Normally, it will all be expense actually. 50, and then click on search now. I will now say 5050. Click on it. So, you desktop is the category on an expense item. 5050 will be the account now. It's a category based charge account for my desktop. So, give a save and then save and close. Save and close. I hope that it will be there now. And again, whatever they go there and then have a look at it. So category based level. Go down and then have a look at it now. It is there. 5050 is there now. Give a cancel and then come out of it. Now let us go on and shop. Click on shop.
So Nana, we do not have to provide an effectivity date there.
If you put it, it will be effective only on this day. If it is blank, it will be infinite effective. That is a standard one, the logic. No?
And this will be only changing or replacing the segment value, right?
Yes, only the segment value only it will be replacing it actually.
And can we change the whole three segment?
I don't know. You have to write a custom mapping set otherwise. If that period one is not over, custom tomorrow I will not teach you about how to create your custom mapping set actually.
Okay, Nana sir, because you know I just learned we can also change whole segment.
Yeah, it's all possible. Everything is possible. Tomorrow we will now teach you about how to create your own mapping set that I'm going to be using tab and tag. Tab and tag, I'm going to teach you about how to do it now. So now this seeded one is written only for the account. We'll now see whether it works or not. Fine, go to the expense and then click on save and close now. So expense, I'm doing it. So we'll now go there, go to the more task and then click on enter requisition lines now. Go to space. I will now make it as bought fixed prices and services, and then I will now put some description. Fine, go there. I will now change it as bought J05. Then I have to get 5050 as an account now. Fine, come on, come. No, 5050 must be an account. So it's not coming. It's not coming. Employees charge account. This is a problem for us. Fine. 4 years back, that natural account for the category was not at all working. And I will tell you about how we have done this now. Fine. Category based charge account was very, very important in our Muscat implementation. And then they're not coming. And tomorrow we are going to see about how to see the category based charge account using tab and tag. It's a very tough one. It's not coming. It has to come. When employees charge account, it's only coming.
Why did we change to us expense in preferences?
Because this is the expense purchase. For asset purchase, this only will work now. If you go for an asset purchase, what happens? These six only, if you know, is an inventory, if the type is an inventory, these six only will fire. Fine. Only when the type is expense, the other things will fire. This 1007, 1001, items expense account, and then a category based expense account, everything will fire only for when the destination is expense actually. Got it?
Okay.
Whereas the type is inventory on your preferences, one of six only will fire. Nothing else will fire. Got it? So now somebody make an R&D. I might have made some mistakes. Again, make a check now. So here I will go to the manage mapping set and again click on this one category level, whether it is there or not. I click on it. I have a look at it now. So open it up and then look at it. And go there. So for this one, it is there. See here, even if you want space extra, it will gone. It will not work at all. You should give them a list of values. That is why financials don't like the seeded ones at all. They create their own then with all the list of values actually. Every mapping set they used to create. Because creating a mapping set is not a what's called a rocket science actually. They can easily create it. Tomorrow we are going to create one mapping set and then show it to you. And they create all the mapping. In the Saudi project, nothing, no seeded is used at all. They have used everything on their own actually. That is why don't touch this at all. Fine. If you touch it and then if you make a mistake, gone. And remember, we are all working on some few values only. If it is thousands of values, and then if you make one mistake here, they will not sit on your head and then you have to go on and what happens, let us say this is working, let us say. And then you're given one space because of which it is not working. You have to go dig and then every 24 hours it will not take for you to debug it actually. That is why try to avoid taking up this responsibility of accounting. Purchasing accounting, try to avoid. If it is forced on you, you don't have any other go. Now, I'm not very sure about whether this is going to work or it is a bug is still there or I have made any mistake or not. I'm not very clear upon this.
Nana sir, might be the input source two are there, no? Requisition BU and procurement category.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. See, you requisitioning BU and then procurement category, isn't it? Both the inputs are given now. They are given both the inputs now.
So do we need to assign it to the employee?
Huh? There is no other input at all. These two inputs has to give this output now.
Nana, when you will create
to the employee?
What is it?
Do we need to attach this category to the employee?
Not necessary. Employee category assignment, where it is? There is no such employee category assignment at all. There is no
we saw that earlier, right? No.
We are not
doing that.
Expense account, we are given the line manager, but the employee do not. Employee's charge account as an expense account. That is the only thing. Might not be the category. Employee do not have any association to any category, even in EBIS also. So this is no fail. So we have to see category based charge account and then tab and tag tomorrow.
Nana, when you will be doing the customized one we will be creating mapping set with the category and natural account, it will work.
That's why it worked as it. For us,
actually, that is the seeded one created by application.
Why this is not working? Tell me. But financials will now have their own mapping sets. I will not teach you tomorrow about how to get a mapping set now, actually. And then they normally do everything on their own only. Because it's not a big rocket science. It's a very easy one. They put every list of values over here and then they know how to do it. It's not a very easy task. It's a very tough task. And then some of the implementations I have seen that they don't do any of the seeded ones at all. This is not working or I made a mistake. I'm still not clear. Okay, fine with that. So we'll now continue on this tomorrow. Now, fine. If it is difficult, can you put on the participants pane a slow icon now? If it is okay, and give a green tick. We know how many of you are giving green tick. Please note down now. Fine. In the participants pane, if you are finding it okay, can you give a green tick mark? And then if you're finding it difficult, what happens? You give a go slow. So that means what you have to understand, you have to study and then understand it. Can you put your ranking on this particular topic now? Fine. So Chitra is now saying it's difficult. Fine. So she has now put a greater, go faster, go slower, anything is okay now. Fine. CMSR is now saying, you will not see anybody putting a green tick mark. Fine. See, Indra has understood it. Karthik has understood it.
Sorry, how to give that?
You go to the click on the participants pane and then put it now. Click on the participants pane. Please note down the names of the people who are good at it now. And remember, tomorrow, if you have to work on it, they will now be great help to you now. And if you're getting stuck, you can do it now. Fine. Kishore is saying impossible to understand now. Kishore has put an X mark now. Fine. Anil has understood it. Fine. Anil has understood it now.
Nana, for the first time, it is very difficult. If you are in the second class, it will be very easy so that everyone. In the first attempt, it is look like it is difficult, but at the second attempt, it is very, very easy.
Maybe, yeah.
For you, it's very, very easy.
Vinay Narula is an excellent guy, actually. Fine. Karthikeyan has put a thumbs up, actually. Fine. He is now understanding it very good. Fine. Chitra.
Actually, I put a wrong one. Slow down.
Paraprasad has understood. Abhirami, our Japan Abhirami has understood. Anil Ashok has understood it very nicely. Fine, go there. And then whenever you have this work in the field, contact them. Fine, go there. Karthi is very good. Fine, go there. Who else is there now? And then Raghu has understood it very well. Rajaraman has understood it very well. Ravi Ranjan Kumar. Please, all of you, please take a note of these people who have understood it very well now. They will all be of a great help to you when you are stuck in the field, actually. It's a very complex topic. I don't say that it's the easy one, but they have understood it. Ten Rajan from Singapore, he has understood it. Good. That's excellent now. So any other questions on this topic now? Fine. Now question session is now open now. It is 8:30 and then now it's a question session actually.
Is a destination type expense or inventory. So that is the trigger, right? For this.
Exactly. That is the trigger. If the destination type is going to be expense or inventory, that is the trigger for all these things now. Fine. Very correct now, fine. So we know that's very correctly told. I will again share the screen and then tell me now, fine. So in the preferences, what you give is what? This is what is, we go there. If it is expense inventory, the first six rows are applicable. And then if it is going to be expense, the remaining will come into picture actually. This one, and then items expense account, and then your category based account, everything will come into picture if the destination is going to be expense. So that is the trigger. Very correct, Vinod.
Yes. Nana, it is the same for EBS also, right?
EBS is also same. It is the same for EBS also.
So in the EBS at the requisition, okay, we will give it in the when you are creating a and for purchase requisition.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the purchase, I have not shown you on purchase order. The same thing is applicable on purchase requisition also. Any other doubts anybody has got? Tain Rajan, Varaprasad, Vikas R has also understood it. Very good, fantastic. Please note down the people who have put a green tick mark. They will be of great help to you. Fine, take a word file and then put the names with you now. So when you're getting stuck in the field, you have to only talk to them and then because I am also very totally new. Fine, whatever I know, I have told you. And then if you get any other complex requirements, you have to understand. Fine. The basic rule is what? Whether the type is expense or inventory. That is the basic one on the preferences basically.
So these all are the charge accounts which you have mentioned. These all are purchase charge account.
The three accounts are there in purchasing. One is a charge account, one is an accrual account, one is a variance account. Fine. So variance do not have any much of a change. Fine. There will be a common variance for
actually,
all things.
My
whatever is the asset that, expense doesn't everything variance is the same. Whereas you have a different accrual. We have an asset accrual and then expense accrual. That also we are going to see tomorrow.
So Nana, when we do miscellaneous issue.
Yeah.
So the account which we choose, charge account, that charge account will be different from purchase charge account.
Exactly. That will be different. I will be demoing when you perform a miscellaneous transaction now. Fine. That is the only thing which I know. Fine. Sometime back, Vinay Narula was asking me that when you perform a movement request from an asset to expense of inventory, how the account will be hit, I don't know. That part is not known to me at all. So whatever we have seen is all purchasing accounting and not inventory accounting. Inventory accounting, again, I will not tell you, I will show you one document for this now, fine, whether you have to go on the ding, and then you have to sit along with our financial team and then see this now. So there is no, what happens, a purchasing accounting for inventory, everything is financial accounting. For the inventory, the total thing is a financial accounting. Only for purchasing, we have a separate analysis for charge account. Got it?
Sir, what about budgetary expense?
It is all come now, fine, budgetary is there, fine. So I don't know budget, fine. So if somebody can look at it at the budget, fine. So we have two types of budget. One is there are two types of budget.
Cost budget and revenue.
No.
Expense and revenue.
No. The different
encumbrance.
Encumbrance accounting. Right. There is an encumbrance accounting with the companies, fine. One is an obligation, one is a commitment actually. Fine, that will be hitting. It is already configured, but I don't know because first of all, budget has to be set in GL and then that has to be configured in procurement. That part is not known to me at all. There is one obligation encumbrance is there, one commitment encumbrance is there. Fine. How to configure that, I don't know. If anybody knows it, please teach others now. Fine. Budget and encumbrance has come already long time back in Fusion, but I am the training program, nobody teaches and then none of the financial guys also teaches.
Sir, sub-inventory, expense sub-inventory is used.
Yes, we use the expense sub-inventory. Now, fine. I told you, there is a maintenance shop near the furnace. The maintenance sub-inventory is only going to do what? Cleaning of the furnace, lubricating the furnace, everything. So they are all called expense sub-inventories. So whatever is issued to the expense sub-inventory will be used only for maintenance, actually.
But they can also use asset sub-inventory and
Sub-inventory, then what happens? Your asset value is going nowhere at all. Out of 1,000 liters, if you have issued 50 liters of kerosene for cleaning, fine. So the system will now say, I have 50 liters in our maintenance sub-inventory. But actually, that will be all used, consumed actually. How we are going to account for the consumption actually? So that is why we have to keep it as an expense sub-inventory and then what happens, expense it out. In practical, what happens, there are plenty of expense sub-inventories like this, where you consume the material actually, consume the asset.
No, but if we are consuming the kerosene and while issuing, we are putting it on the expense account.
Yeah.
So then also we can track na, from the expense but account.
The sub-inventory is always an expense. The moment you move it, it is expensed out. That's all gone. And if you want to make a back movement from an expense to asset, you have to have an audit approval actually. In EBIS, we have a profile also. So only when the profile is set, yes, we can move it back from expense into asset actually. Otherwise, audit will not allow it on. Audit will have a big objection whenever you're moving from, you already expensed it out, and then let us say 50 liters, out of which 30 liters only you used, and the remaining 20, you want to bring it back to whatever the asset sub-inventory, you have to have audit permission actually. Otherwise, during audit, they will not question you.
So
profile, sir. Movement of what happens, expense to asset. INV, expense to asset is a profile. Here also, there will be some profiles basically. That will be, if it is set to yes, then only it will allow you. Otherwise, it will allow you, but accounting will fail actually. Supply chain is not having connection with accounting, but accounting will fail.
So this is the case of kerosene, like we are using it for furnace. But yeah, in the case of like we are like cotton and greasing,
yeah.
So that we can use.
Item itself is an expense item. No?
Huh?
Item itself is an expense item, is not having any cost. You issue it in an expense sub inventory. Doesn't matter.
No, we can also use in an asset sub inventory. No?
Yeah. See, I have a cotton waste. So cotton waste is an expense item. I receive it in the asset sub inventory. So the value of the asset sub inventory will not go up at all. It's zero. And then when you issue the expense sub inventory again, zero to zero, nothing will be there.
Okay,
fine. Costing will be asset affected only when asset to asset happens. Now, asset into expense into non-tract expenses, no accounting at all. It's a very complex topic. It's not a very easy topic actually.
Nana, when it comes to the sub-inventory
uh-huh.
account, mm-hmm. so at the time of requisition, the sub-inventory, if we don't select, the charge account will not be done, right?
It will not pick up from org actually.
True.
They're not given
but it when it comes to the, so requisition will convert to the purchase order will receive the goods, right?
Yeah.
At that time, whatever the sub-inventory be selected, that will be received.
Yes, right? Exactly. At the time of receipt, what happens is that will now override your PO's account actually.
True.
If it is different, if it is a different combination, then the receipt accounting will now come into picture and then that will now override this.
That's
to begin with, they are given an account and then if you are not doing as per that asset into asset or something like that, if you are not doing it, then that whatever you are receiving it, that will now supersede this.
In the previous class, Dana, you said that PO approval will not have any accounting, but charge account will be mandatory.
Of course.
However, you will not keep that.
Variance are mandatory. All the three are mandatory. For requisition, charge and variance are only mandatory. For a purchase order, charge, accrual and variance, all the three accounts are mandatory.
All the three accounts are mandatory. But whatever on the purchase order, we will not finalize it. But at the time of receiving, whatever the charge account will be...
To begin with, what happened, these accounts are populated. And then during receiving, it may even change. Tomorrow, we are going to begin with what our tab and tad. And then I will now try to set up what's called a category-based charge account using tab and tad. That's again a very tough part. So whatever you're saying,
you'll be telling about the accrual account and various accounts.
Of course. Purchase order means what accrual
so,
is. Now,
yeah,
I will not talk about accrual. We are only still requisition. Fine with that. Accrual will not.
No, that's fine, sir. Yeah. So when you do that, so you'll be doing again the same as comparison between.
Yeah. Accrual has got two types. One is an asset accrual, one is an expense accrual. I will not demonstrate both of them to you.
Okay. Yeah. EBS and Fusion, both. Yeah.
In Fusion, I'll show you the asset accrual as well as expense accrual also when I go into purchase orders.
The charge account will change, right, Nana? Charge account will be, if it's an inventory item, inventory charge account.
No.
Inventory.
Charge account will not change at all. There is no change on the charge.
If it's expense items, if it's expense item.
One second. So these are the six ones which are same for requisitions as well as purchase orders also. There is no change at all on this. If the destination is going to be inventory, these six will be applicable for requisition as well as purchase orders. No change at all. So this is on the charge account. The charge account will be picked up from any of these six. If it is going to be an expense destination, this, and then items expense account, and then the category based account, everything will come into picture. That is true for both purchase requisitions and purchase orders.
If it is a, even if it is an expense item, doesn't matter.
If one of the six, that means what? As long as the destination is inventory. If the destination is going to be expense, then these two and other things will know default it is. It is true for both requisitions as well as purchase orders. Any other doubt, please ask me. Fine.
Nana Shakti here.
Yeah.
If the inventory is not implemented,
yeah.
So at the time, if you show that employee expense account, right, defaulting in employee master,
okay.
Whether it is an option to import that one?
Oh God, you are asking so many questions. Inventory is not implemented. Okay, fine. Inventory is not there. Then employee's expense account. How inventory and employee's expense account are coming into picture? What is the relationship between these two?
No
any relationship at all. You told first of all inventory is not implemented. Okay, fine.
Now you only purchase and payables alone implemented.
Okay. In that case, the employee's expense account, if you choose expense there, employee's expense account will now come into the purchase requisitions as well as purchase orders also.
It will come.
And then it will be a two-way PO. In which case, what happens? We are not going to receive anything at all.
No, no. For 50 employees are there, we need to map individually or is there any import option will be there?
I don't know. That importing and all, I am not aware of it. Okay? Whether you have to use the FBDA import or not. Import, Surya is a specialist actually. And then Vignesh is also a specialist. And Vignesh normally doesn't come at all. So keep these two people's numbers handy now. Fine. Their contact details handy. And then if you have to import and all, you only have to. I don't know whether any FBDA template is there for importing 50 employees charge account through FBDA. I'm not aware of it. You only have to see it.
Okay.
Talk to them. Fine. Sati. They will now help you out.
Nana, change of topic.
Tell me.
Would you have time to?
Yeah. Now, after 12 o'clock, also you can listen. No problem at all. No, the class is over now. Those who are in Australia and then Japan, they can go for sleep now. Right? So, the class is now over for them. Now, only discussions are happening. If you're still possible for you to wake, then you can listen to the discussions actually. And then you can also participate. But, class for the day is over actually. Tell me.
So, when I log in as a SCM student and then go into supply chain planning, I'm not seeing any infolet. Is there a way that I can?
That is all. I don't know. Even fine. No. Some mistakes, some problems in the machine now. Fine. Okay. I don't know how to configure infolets at all. Those questions.
I see blank. Yeah.
Okay. That is not a topic of anything which is relevant to the procurement. You just ask.
Nana, for receiving the, it was not showing, and you did the setup, and it was showing, right? So what did you do?
I am not receiving at all. First of all, receiving is not at setup. You are now going to land up on error, and then I will not show you during purchase orders actually. Three types of charge account. No, there are three accounts that are mandatory for the procurement. One is a charge account, one is an accrual account, one is a variance account. These are three accounts which has to be done for this.
You sure only charge account? What about variance and accrual account?
Variance will not have any effect at all because variance will not vary. Whether it is an asset in expense or expense in asset, variance will be same. Whereas the accrual will vary. So there is one asset accrual and then one is expense accrual. Accrual will come into picture only on purchase orders actually, not on requisitions. I will not tell you at the time of purchase orders. There are only two variants for the accruals. One is an asset accrual and then one is an expense accrual. That we will be discussing about it in purchase orders actually. Come on, tell me. Whatever is the question you can ask.
Nana sir, tell me. What is the, like, in procurement, everything involves around categories?
Yeah. Exactly what happens is all category based basically. And category is a dominant one in procurement actually. Everything is revolving around category structure. If it is an
for
destination, then category doesn't come into picture. If it is an expense destination, category is a very dominant one.
In expense, like if it is a category, then how they will like track? I mean, I'm not able to imagine these scenarios.
I don't know on case. In Muscat, they were building buildings. So building one, how much of cement is issued. Building 18, how much of cement is issued. Right? Cement is a category. So category-based, building-based reports, we can very well take note. Building is basically a project. So project-based, category-based, we can very well take a report. So they will not take a report and then analyze everything for their fine-tuning of their future purchases, basically. Got it? This is only for analysis. So spend analysis is the important activity as far as procurement module is concerned. Now. So there is a major benefit. So they will not show you on your, what happens, your profit and loss statement. They will not compare 4 years before and then this year after implementation, how much this expense has come down. Right? This is called your, what happens, a payback. Sometimes Oracle gives you a payback of 18 months. Now. You buy it and then within 18 months, whatever you have spent, you will be getting back. For which once when they give assurance, they will now constantly monitor your implementation. Actually, your implementation will be monitored by them. If they don't give any payback, Accenture or Infosys, whomsoever is implementing, they will not even care. But payback in Chennai, in Madras, we have one factory in Avadi. They have sold 3 modules for 2 crores in EBIS basically. And they have given a payback of 24 months. And then every step of implementation, Oracle's people will come and then have a look at it before you go ahead actually. So that way, what happens? The payback is the one which is basically optimizing your spend actually. That is the purpose of a procurement module.
Okay. So for expense, like for each and every small item also, I mean, for small expense item also, they will track it as a different category.
Exactly. Correct? Category wise.
Okay. Thank you.
What is payback? I'm not getting what is. Payback.
You are a customer now. I am an Oracle. You have purchased, you have paid around 20 lakhs for the procurement module. Now I am now going to give you an assurance that once when you buy it, within 24 months, you will now get back your money. So for the last 4 years, they will now see your balance sheets on which how much of purchasing spending is there. Let us say it's going to be 1 crore. Fine. And the balance sheet. And then after implementation, you will now find it will come down to 75 lakhs for the same profit and loss, for a comparable profit and loss. Right? For a same profit and loss, they will now load the factors and then finally show you that you have already got back the money in 24 months.
Okay.
Procurement spending, actually. That is called payback.
Yeah, sir.
Is it the same for order management?
Mm-hmm. Order management is basically what sales maximization, actually. So order management is a tool to automate your processing only.
Correct, that's what.
Yeah, there that is what happens is this thing will not come into picture. There
are Oracle guarantee increase in sales.
No. Order management is what it facilitates your sale actually. You can even buy and sell, make and sell, and then transfer and sell. And then there are so many such functionalities are there. So I don't know the payback for order management. Fine. You have to only talk to the your success. Customer success manager, he will not tell you what is the payback for order management.
Okay.
In what measure they do it, I don't know. And every model will be having a different measure actually. And okay. Not that Oracle will be giving you a payback for every model. I don't know whether it's there or not. I'm not also sure. But procurement, it is there.
So Nana, when you say that this for procurement, they show that, okay, you have gained something. So is there something that they show?
You're not gained. You have reduced the spend, actually. That is what the ultimate one is. You have not gained anything. The spend reduction is achieved, actually.
And say, for example, they, like in 4 years, they were unable to save. So is Oracle going to compensate with that money?
I don't know. The legal functionality and all, I don't know. Fine. You only have to ask somebody.
This is tricky concept.
The moment they got into agreement, I think from that
time. Sometimes to get the customers, you know, promise so many things, but you may not even deliver it also.
Yeah, marketing.
Marketing tactics, actually.
Nana, Shashank here. Yeah, I wanted to ask in transfer orders, for India localization, I don't see anywhere how the GST is handled.
You have one GST specialist in this group now, fine. Tapsi Patro.
Tapsi Patro.
Tapsi Patro is a GST specialist. Talk to her and then try to contact them.
Okay.
She's already implemented a GST. So whatever is the GST one, you cannot talk to her.
Okay. Thanks.
Any other questions now? I told you marketing technique, and then finally, what happens if they are unable to give a payback? They will now find all sorts of reasons. No, you have not done like this because of which you have not got the payback. Like,
yes. What happens? Yes. No?
The marketing team will now give some excuses, and then they will now come out of it. Actually,
is it if it is India localization? It is like a client in US had implemented Fusion. And their Indian subsidiary for which they have implemented GST?
I don't know. I have no idea at all. You okay. have to follow all the GST related questions, contact Tapsika. So you will know. She's an expert on this now. Right? You can even discuss with her privately. Actually.
Okay.
Anna, sir.
Tell me.
Like if any charge accounts or anything, any of the three accounts are not correct. So what will be the actual impact like on
profit and loss statement will not show properly at all. Okay. The profit and loss statement will not show anything, and then they will not correct it at the journal level. At the journal level, they will not correct all the journal entries.
Transaction flow.
Will you have made some thousand transactions wrong with the wrong account. So yeah. The GL team has to sit and then correct everything at the journal entry level. I've seen people doing it day and night.
So for the same account, journals will be created, right? Whatever account which are getting derived from
GL, procurement. It will all be finally pushed into GL. No? Fine. All the accounts will be pushed into GL.
Pushed into GL.
GL is only going to account everything and then show you. For purchasing, this much of money. For inventory transactions, this money. For sales, this much. Fine. Everything it will now given the profit and loss statement, actually.
Transactions will be completed like normal.
Yeah, transaction will have no problem at all, even if you put a wrong account. No. Wrong amounts will not have any problem at all. If you go and then put a bomb in Madras airport, it will definitely explode. You are not supposed to do it. But if you make a wrong account, it will transaction will be through. It will never stop at all. Any other questions from anybody else?
How this inventory accounting? So, like the case which they came back for moment transfer order. This inventory accounting.
I don't know about accounting for a transfer order actually. That's why I told you. I will not show you a miscellaneous transaction accounting. Fine. Rest of the things you only have to do. You know, right? So it's basically financial accounting. Inventory transactions are financial accounting. Out of which only one I know. The remaining I have not tested it. Only when I know the details, I can test it. But since I don't know, fine, I'll just leave it as such. Which mapping set you had to put all these things? No, fine, that is a real big thing. Any other doubts? Otherwise, we'll not call it now.
You are saying some example.
Tell me. Hello, your voice is again gone now. Can you again speak now? Your voice is gone now.
Is asking about the planning central springboard, right? Actually, we have to give the access for the plan in terms of public, then only the springboard will be able to see that with the data.
Mm-hmm. Where exactly it is now, Surya?
In the supply planning, mm-hmm. when you are open the managed plans and action, open that plan, and you have to give the access for managed tables, graphs, and all. You have to create a group
then
and make it as public.
If you're given it public, what will happen now?
You can able to see the screen with the, all the data. Graphs.
You're saying about infolets or what exactly is your answer?
Yeah, in the planning center, it's not an infolet. It's a table, graphs and all will have access.
Sort of a, what's called, sort of an infolet. Right? So yes, you're saying about, somebody was saying that the infolets were not visible and all. Right? You can talk to Surya regarding this.
Yeah, Satya was asking. Mm-hmm. Satya was asking.
Yeah.
Satya, you can talk to Surya directly. He will now give you more information on this.
I think to see those infolets graph, we need to give access to that data security so that the data will be visible into that infolets graphs.
Mm-hmm. For the planning central, data security is not required.
Okay.
Depends upon the planner who has created the plan, he have to give the access as a public one. It will you can able to see the others one as well if it is a public.
Okay, I was not aware. Sorry, Surya.
Tomorrow we are going to see this Raipur's Vinay's what happens. One line is for one approver, second line is for seven approver. Second approver, one is approving, second is rejecting. What will happen? He asked me. I also don't know. We are going to test this also tomorrow.
Yeah, no, no, I need to do some exercises on that one, so I'll be definitely.
Tomorrow we'll not do it now. We'll not do sure. it.
Thank you.
It is Raipur Vinay, actually.
Yeah.
on the Vinay Narula is from Delhi. He might have gone now. He was always threatening us with a hard stop, actually. Okay. Any other questions from anybody else? You're free to ask. If I know, I will definitely answer. Good then. Since there is no other question, we'll not call it. We'll not meet. Yeah.
Sir, can we create the? I mean, creating users manually, it is frustrating. Can we create it through FBDI template? Do we have any?
Surya, I have around 1,000 legal users. Can we create through FBDI?
FBDI, I have not tried, Nana. But using REST APIs, we can create.
Using what?
REST API.
Oh, REST API can create now.
Yeah.
1,000 legal users can be created using REST API. That is what he's saying now. But he is not aware of whether we can use a FBDA template or not.
What is that REST API? Can I know that?
You can talk to Surya personally now. Surya, you know that? Have you done it?
Yeah, yeah. I did that. Yeah.
Okay. Kavya, you can talk to Surya separately. Fine.
Okay.
And get the details regarding the REST API. We'll teach you everything also.
Anna.
Tell me.
I want to discuss one scenario. We have received one item and I want to show the on-hand quantity, but the valuation should be zero.
You create a dummy column and then show is a zero in the report.
No, I am directly consuming that material.
Okay.
I am directly consuming whenever I'm receiving.
And you wanted to take a report, you only want to show only the on-hand quantity and not the value, isn't it?
Yes.
Report you can very well make in whichever way you want. You make one dummy column with all the values as zero, right? And then do it. The end customer will not know anything at all, no, on the value. He don't want to see the value, or he want to see the value as zero.
You want to see the value as zero.
You create a dummy column and then populate with zero as a static value. He can very well eat him now.
Nana, this expense item, when we receive it, we can give an asset subinventory or an expense subinventory, right?
Exactly. You've seen all the six combinations, no? It comes under that one.
So if we receive, the quantity is tagged. So what you said is quantity will be tracked, but not the price.
Yeah, not the price, and the cost.
Cost.
See, there are three types of money is involved. One is what? List price. List price is the purchase price. Price list is the sale price. And then cost price is the cost price. Right? So you should be having a clarity between these three.
So cost price will define an item.
Yeah, no, not an item. We are going to see costing now. Right?
Okay.
Costing, we'll not see, but how to give the cost price of an item actually.
So if an expense subinventory is non-tracked, and if you receive it an expense item, then how the quantity will be tracked?
Quantity will not be tracked because subinventory is not tracked. You cannot track it at all.
So
10 reams of paper onto a stationary subinventory, the stationary subinventory will know, so zero quantity only.
Okay. And but so you said that for financial accounting, all everything will be tracked.
Of course, the financial accounting, even one paisa spent will be accounted. Cost accounting is approximately accurate. Some of them we will not consider at all. Cost, cotton waste, screws, washers, nuts, cheapo, I don't want the money at all. Well, that way cost accounting will not say. Okay, then yeah, we'll now call it a day now. Fine. So we'll now meet at 5:30 PM India tomorrow. Bye for now.
Thanks.
Okay.
Thank you, Nana.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.